टू कॉल
सर, गुड मॉर्निंग।
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड नो व्हाट इज ए वैलिड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट। द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट दोज एग्रीमेंट विच आर एनफोर्सेबल बाय लॉ एंड एज पर सेक्शन 10 ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एक्ट 1872 ओनली दोज एग्रीमेंट विच आर एनफोर्स्ड बाय लॉ विच आर मेड बाय द फ्री कंसेंट ऑफ द पार्टीज कॉम्पिटेंट टू कॉन्ट्रैक्ट फॉर ए लॉफुल कंसिडरेशन। नाउ इफ ए कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इज सेटिस्फाइंग ऑल द कंडीशंस ऑफ सेक्शन 10 ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एक्ट 1872 वेदर इट इज ए वैलिड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट। एनीबडी कैन टेल ए कॉन्ट्रैक्ट which is satisfying the all conditions of section 10 of contract act 1872 whether it is a valid contract?
Sir,
yes sir.
Hello, is a contract satisfying all conditions of section 10 of contract act 1872 whether it is a valid contract?
Yes, sir.
No. As government contracts are, the government contract must satisfy not only the requirement of Contract Act 1872 but also Article 299 of Constitution of India. Means CPWD contracts are made using the power of Union of India. Hence, all agreement, all contract. should be made by President of India and should be executed on behalf of President of India. And as work is to be executed, hence the agreement should be in written. Hence, a government contract should satisfy this requirement, otherwise it will be void ab initio. Void ab initio means invalid from the very, very early stage. Now, we come, why this GCC is required? Both the party should seriously consider the contract for performance of the contract, not for breach of the contract. Or both of the parties should oblige their obligations, obey their obligations so that work may be executed within targeted period. It is on the part of the contractor, means one party, that he should execute the work within the stipulated period. There is also obligation on other party, means on you, on the department, that whatever is required, site is to be handover within targeted period, drawings and other documents which are to be given.
Voice mein bahut disturbance hai.
Hello.
वॉइस में बहुत डिस्टरबेंस है
सर। आपका पीपीटी नहीं दिखाई दे रहा है।
हेलो
सर, आपका पीपीटी शेयर
बताऊंगा ना, पीपीटी शेयर करूंगा।
ठीक है।
व्हाई जीसीसी इज रिक्वायर्ड? ओनली टू इंटरप्रेट द क्लॉजेस ऑफ द जीसीसी अकॉर्डिंगली सो दैट वी मे ओबे आवर ऑब्लिगेशन by both the parties, by the contractor and by the department. Hence GCC is
hello
legitimate green. Obligation sir,
जोर से बोल।
हेलो
हाँ
सर, legitimate obligations,
yes legitimate obligations, yes
condition of contract is a legitimated obligations to prove in an arbitrary manner.
Yeah.
Both parties should be agreed.
Yes.
Yes. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Now we come clause one. First clause is for performance guarantee. First, we will discuss for construction works, then for EPC and maintenance simultaneously. And during discussion of these clauses, we will discuss the manual provisions also simultaneously connected with that clause. First, clause for performance guarantee for construction work, the contractor shall submit an irrevocable performance guarantee of 5% of the tendered amount in addition to other deposit mentioned elsewhere in the contract for his proper performance of the contract agreement, not withstanding and or without prejudice to any other provisions in the contract, within period specified in Schedule F from the date of issue of letter of acceptance. Within period specified in Schedule F, it is up to the NIT approving authority to give the time, but this time period should not be more than 7 days. Maybe 1 to 7 days, but it should not be more than 7 days. Further period with provision of interest per day of the performance guarantee amount may be kept in NIT if required NIT approving authority in case contractor is unable to procure performance guarantee within stipulated period due to unavoidable circumstances. If contractor has not submitted the performance guarantee within the period stipulated in Schedule F, which cannot be more than 7 days, then if the contractor requests to the engineering charge to submit the same, the engineering charge may allow him to deposit performance guarantee, considering the reply given by the contractor why he could not be procure the performance guarantee within the stipulated period. Then, but this period cannot be more than beyond 7 days, further 7 days. And this further beyond 7 days will be allowed only with a percentage interest in percentage of performance guarantee per day. The quantum to be kept, it depends on the NIT approving authority. If the contractor does not submit the performance guarantee within 7 days plus further extended 7 day period, then you cannot accept the performance guarantee submitted by the contractor beyond 14 days. This period of 7 days can be further extended by engineering charge up to maximum period as specified in Schedule F. What is specified in Schedule F? It should not be more than 7 days. On written request of the contractor stating the reason for delay in procuring the performance guarantee to the satisfaction of the engineering charge. The guarantee shall be in the form of deposit or call receipt of any scheduled bank, banker check of any scheduled bank, or demand draft of any scheduled bank, pay sir, order and scheduled bank in case would, guarantee amount is less than 1 lakh.
May I interrupt you, sir? Hello?
Hello?
हाँ सर, गुड मॉर्निंग सर, मे आई इंटरप्ट यू इन दिस केस इन दिस क्लास सर. सर, इफ अ कॉन्ट्रैक्टर डज नॉट इवन डिपॉजिट द पीजी इवन 7 + 7 days, देन व्हाट एक्शन विल बी टेकन अगेंस्ट दैट कॉन्ट्रैक्टर सर?
फर्स्ट टेंडर विल बी रिकॉल्ड.
टेंडर विल बी, जी सर,
tender will be recalled, yes, and that contract will not be allowed in further re-tender.
That is the only penalty to that contractor, sir, for that particular, yes, yes, work only, sir.
In first instance, it is the only penalty, yes.
Sir, his earnest money deposit will be forfeited.
Nowadays, earnest money is not being deposited, sir.
Unless if earnest money is not deposited, his tender will not be considered.
If he,
no, EMP declaration is given by the contract.
Hello. जिसको पूछना है वो ही ऑन करे अपना बस.
सर, सर मैं पीके भी बोल रहा हूँ सर. ये पीजी जमा करने के लिए फॉर्मेट 1 एंड फॉर्मेट 2 क्या होता है सर?
हेलो,
हेलो, पीजी जमा करने के लिए फॉर्मेट वन एंड फॉर्मेट टू दोनों में डिफरेंस
डिस्कस करूंगा, आगे करूंगा डिस्कस।
और सर अभी पीजी का वैल्यू भी घट गया सर, 3% हो गया है कोरोना।
मैं आऊंगा आने तो
पहले आ रहा हूँ
Now, the performance guarantee shall be initially valid up to stipulated date of completion plus minimum 60 days beyond that. The engineer in charge shall not make a claim under the performance guarantee except for amount to which the President of India is entitled under the contract, notwithstanding and or without prejudice to any other provisions of the contract agreement in the event of the claim of this contract only, the performance guarantee will be claimed only in case number one, failure by the contract to extend the validity of the performance guarantee as described herein above, in which event the engineering charge may claim the full amount of performance guarantee, failure by the contract to pay President of India any amount due either as agreed by the contractor or determined under any of the clause conditions of the agreement, means in present agreement only, within 30 days of service of notice to this effect by the engineering charge. In the event of contract being determined by or
resigned. PPT not shown.
Hello?
PPT not shown in this screen.
PPT?
Not shown in this screen.
Showing sir.
Check karo. Dikh rahi hai.
Dikh rahi hai. Dikh rahi hai.
We are getting.
Sir, in the event of contract being determined or rescinded, but doing by determination of the work means determination of obligation on the as far as performance of the work is concerned of both the parties. Determination means the determination of obligation of the of both of the parties as far as performance of the work is concerned, means department or this is not a termination of the agreement, it is determination of the practical performance of the work and or rescinded means to take up the balance work on the risk and cost of the contractor. Under provision of the any clause, condition of the agreement, the PG shall stand forfeit in full and shall be absolutely at the disposal of President of India. On substantial completion of any work, which has been completed to such an extent that intended purpose of the work is not met and ready to use, then a provisional completion certificate will be recorded by the engineering charge. But doing by substantial completion of the work should be completed to that extent can be used for that purpose, for what purpose it was constructed, means the purpose should be solved, means the services should be completed invariably, then the work should be considered as substantial completion of the work. That the intended purpose of the work is met and ready to use, then a provisional completion certificate will be recorded by the engineering charge. The provisional certificate shall have appended with a list of outstanding balance item work and need to be completed in accordance with the provisions of the contract. The provisional completion certificate shall be recorded by the EE and TS authority in case both authorities are different. Now, as per CPWD Works Manual, up to 10 crores, the work will be inspected by the executive engineer, and more than 10 crore, the work will be inspected before completion by the superintending engineer or by the chief engineer. After recording of completion, provisional completion certificate for the work by the competent authority, the 80% of PG shall be returned to the contractor without any interest. However, in case of contract involving maintenance of building and services, any other work after construction of same building and services other work, then 40% of PG shall be returned to the contractor without any interest. As per latest order, the PG is to be deducted 3% instead of 5% up to tender to be called up to 31-12-21. Those tender which has already been in progress, work in progress, in those cases also the PG is to be deducted only 3%, but in those cases where arbitration or court cases are there, in that case this reduced PG condition will not be applicable. For EPC project, same provisions as for construction works, and for maintenance, same provisions as per construction works, but the PG can be accepted in the form of cash if guarantee amount is less than 10,000. And provision of para 5 of construction work are not applicable for maintenance work. Means, para 5 means substantial completion in the maintenance case is not applicable. It is the only difference. Otherwise, all provisions of performance guarantee applicable for construction work are applicable for maintenance work also. Now we come clause 1A, recovery of security deposit. Construction works. The persons who tender may be accepted here in cold.
PPT is not shown, sir. PPT.
Hello. Hello. Hello.
हेलो
हेलो हाँ बोलिए
सर. वो फॉर्मेट वन और फॉर्मेट टू
मैं बताऊंगा देखूंगा थोड़ा बताऊंगा
सर.
वो जो क्लॉज वन का टू थ्री और फोर ही दिखाई दे रहा है, बाकी जो आप जो बोल रहा है वो पेज दिखाई नहीं दे रहा है.
क्लॉज वन का
क्लॉज वन का जो टू थ्री एंड फोर वो ही अभी दिखाई दे रहा है. हाँ, बाकी जो आप जो बोल रहा है उसका पेज में नहीं दिखाई दे रहा है.
अब दिखाई दे रहा है आपको?
नहीं सर.
सर दिख रहा है कि इंटरनेट
सर दिख रहा है प्रॉब्लम होगा. स्क्रीन टू असिस्टेंट दिख रहा
है, सब कुछ दिख रहा है. सर जी
सब दिख रहा है सर.
रीजन इज और रीजन.
एक्सक्यूज मी सर, आई हैव अ डाउट.
हां
सर,
वेरी गुड.
हेलो.
हां बोलिए बोलिए
सर. देयर इज अ वर्क where contractor has not yet started the work after submission of PG, and we have issued notice under clause 3, but at the situation is like that, the work which was supposed to be done, now it is not required. Means it is our compulsion to close the work, foreclose the work. What should be our action? We should forfeit his PG.
Kitna time ho chuka hai
sir? It is simultaneous. We have issued notice under clause 3. At the same time, now the client doesn't want that work to be done.
Adjudicated.
164.
What time has elapsed from the date of start?
40 days.
42.
40 days. He has not yet started anything.
Then you cannot take action under clause 3A also. Okay. Then you take action under clause 13.
Okay, but at the same time now the work is supposed to be foreclosed because now that work is no more required.
Yeah. But foreclosed under clause 14 karna hai, 13 karna hai.
Sir, it is just that client department is requesting ki that work now we don't require. So what should we do? We simply do the foreclosing of work, or shall we take action against the contractor?
What was the date of start?
Hello.
Whether the contractor has not started the work within that period?
Yes, contractor has not started, then we issued notices. Now the thing is that client is saying we don't require that work because of some compulsion. So we have to foreclose the work. So in that case, what should we take? What should we do?
Action is to be taken as per clause 13.
Okay.
Foreclosure, only foreclosure.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
जब क्लॉज 13 आएगी मैं बताऊंगा, उसमें मैं बताऊंगा आपको.
ओके थैंक
यू. रिकवरी ऑफ सिक्योरिटी डिपॉजिट 1A 2.5% पे टेनर अमाउंट. अब सबको दिखाई दे रहा है कि स्क्रीन पर?
यस सर दिख रहा
है. जो शिकायत कर रहा
है देख रहा है सर, दिख रहा
है. हेलो सर.
हेलो
हेलो.
या
हाँ सर, एक कंफ्यूजन है मुझे रिगार्डिंग परफॉर्मेंस गारंटी. अगर सब्सटेंशियल कंप्लीशन की बात सर कर रहे हैं
जी,
तो उसमें कंस्ट्रक्शन वर्क्स पे तो अगर हमारा जो जिसके लिए प्रोजेक्ट मिंट है वो अगर मिंट हो रहा है तो हम उसको 80% रिलीज कर देते हैं और प्रोविजनल सर्टिफिकेट लगा देते हैं.
जी जी.
बट इन केस ऑफ मेंटेनेंस देयर इज नो एनी प्रोविजन, बट उसमें नीचे 40% की जो बात लिखी हुई है
जी
स्लाइड में, उसका क्या मतलब?
ये है, अगर हमारे उसमें आजकल इन ग्लोबल टेंडर व्हाट आर वी आर डूइंग मेंटेनेंस वर्क ऑफ 5 years और मोर आल्सो इन दी ओरिजिनल टेंडर वी आर इंक्लूडिंग मेंटेनेंस वर्क अप टू सम इयर्स 5 years और मोर इन ओरिजिनल टेंडर इटसेल्फ. इन केस मेंटेनेंस इज इंक्लूडेड इन दैट टेंडर देन ओनली 80% दिस 50% will be released. The rest part will be kept as security deposit.
Okay, sir.
In global tender, in India also, we are keeping some maintenance with original tender for some 4 or 5 years.
Okay. The both the works incorporated in the single tender.
Original tender, not single tender. Original tender.
Original tender. Okay.
Original tender.
पीपीटी इसके पहले जो आई पीजी वाली वो दिखा दी.
लेट अस स्टार्ट फर्दर. डिटेक्शन ऑफ सिक्योरिटी डिपॉजिट सर डिटेक्शन विल बी मेड एंड हेल्ड बाय गवर्नमेंट बाय वे ऑफ सिक्योरिटी डिपॉजिट unless he has deposited the amount of security at the rate mentioned above in cash or in the form of government security.
पहले के हमको ये participant नहीं दिखाई पड़ रहा, क्या यहाँ से होगा क्या? Participant के नाम नहीं दिखाई पड़
रहा. ओह PPT देख ले, participant बाद में देख लेना.
चले आगे. In case of fixed deposit receipt. Hello. In case a fixed deposit receipt of any fund is by the contractor to the government as part of security deposit, the bank is unable to make payment against the said FDR, the loss caused thereby shall fall on the contractor, and the contractor shall forthwith on demand furnish additional security to the government to make good the deficit. All compensation or the other sums of money payable by the contractor under the terms of this contract may be deducted from or paid by the sale of a sufficient part of his security deposit or from the interest arising therefrom or from any sums which may be due to or may become due to the contract by government on any account whatsoever. The security deposit as deducted above can be released against bank guarantee issued by a scheduled bank on its accumulation to a minimum of rupees 5 lakh. If security deposit detector already is more than 5 lakh, then it can be released to the contractor on production of bank guarantee, subject to the condition that the amount of such bank guarantee except last month shall not be less than 5 lakh. Provided further that the validity of bank guarantee shall be the conformity with the provisions of containing clause 17. What is the provisions of clause 17? 12 months in case the estimated cost is more than 10 lakhs and 6 months if it is less than 10 lakh. So your bank guarantee should be validated अप टू पीरियड अप टू विच कंस्ट्रक्शन इज टू बी डन एंड अप टू द मेंटेनेंस पीरियड. इन केस ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इन्वॉल्विंग मेंटेनेंस बिल्डिंग सर्विसेज एनी अदर वर्क आफ्टर कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ सेम बिल्डिंग एंड सर्विसेज अदर वर्क देन 50% ऑफ पी जी शैल बी रिटेन एज सिक्योरिटी डिपॉजिट द सेम विल बी रिटर्न ईयर बाय प्रोपोर्शनेटली. The government paper standard as security will be taken at 5% below its market price or its face value, whichever is less. Market price means आज के दिन market पर क्या price है उस government paper की, face value means उसके ऊपर क्या लिखा हुआ है. The provisions of recovery of security report for EPC projects are also same. And for maintenance works also the same provisions are there. Now, very most important clause is clause 2.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Hello, sir. मैं एक क्वेश्चन था मेरा. ये सर जैसे हमको
थोड़ा पूछो
ना. रिलीज करनी है आगे. तो उस केस में सर वो बैंक गारंटी की वैलिडिटी कितनी होगी सर, अगर हमारा काम अभी खत्म होने में 6 महीने और बाकी हैं. तो क्या
6 महीने 6 महीने प्लस 12 महीने और 6 महीने
प्लस 6 महीने
प्लस 12 महीने एनी ग्रांटेड क्लॉज 5 क्लॉज 12 क्लॉज 15
जी. तो मेरे को एक्चुअली 12 महीने के अलावा जितना टाइम बाकी है उतना ऐड करके उसकी वैलिडिटी लेनी होगी.
एजुकेशन बैलेंस टाइम प्लस मेंटेनेंस पीरियड प्लस any extension granted without levy of compensation.
Okay.
जो further period grant किया है.
अच्छा.
Maintenance कहाँ से शुरू होगी, जहाँ से date of completion होगी उसकी.
जी जी.
तो date of completion means कहाँ तक होगा, जहाँ तक उसने work खत्म किया है plus उसको period. Now very important clause clause 2. In this case you have to take action very cautiously and you should know the provisions of every provision of this clause very very particularly because it deals with clause 2 itself, provisions of clause 5 also, and if you are not taking action accordingly your action in clause 2 be invalid. Invalid means action taken by you will be invalid. So you have to take action under clause 2 very cautiously means considering the provisions of clause 5 in mind, then apply to the provisions of this clause, particularly when the work is not going as per milestone, but you are not giving any notice to the contractor and you are issuing a notice under clause 2, then your action will be invalid. If the contractor fails to maintain the required progress in time of clause 5. What is the terms of clause 5? The work should be executed as per milestone fixed. Milestone fixed. If the contractor fails to maintain the required progress in terms of clause 5, or to complete the work and clear the site on or before the contract or justify action date of completion as per clause 5, excluding any extension granted under clause 5.5. 5.5 means it is the hindrance under this clause is on the part of the contractor and levy is to be taken invariably under clause 5.5. So, extend date of completion as per clause 5, excluding any extension granted under clause 5.5, as well as any extension granted under clause 12. Under clause 12 means time allowed for extra work done. And 15. Clause 15 means extension granted for suspension of the work. He shall, without prejudice to any other right or remedy available under the law to the government on account of such breach, pay as compensation the amount calculated at the rates stipulated below, as the authority specified in Schedule F may decide, on the amount of tender value of the work for every completed day or month as determined that the progress remains below that specified in clause 5 or that the work remains incomplete. Action will be taken in case the work remains incomplete on or before the stipulated date of completion or the progress is not as per terms of clause 5. Terms of clause 5 means the progress is not as per milestone fixed for the during stipulated period. The compensation for delay with minimum rate of 1% per month of delay to be computed per day basis based on quantum of damage suffered due to stated delay on the part of the contractor. So, taking or operation of this clause, before operation of this clause, you should know very well that what will be the quantum of damage per month or per day so that you can take action on this clause. Otherwise, your action will be invalid. The compensation may be maximum 1%, but subjected to the, it will be based on the quantum of damage suffered due to stated delay on the part of the contractor. So, you should know what will be the loss if the work is complete, is delayed by 1 day, or 2 days, 1 month, or 2 months. The details should be known in advance. Provided always that the total amount of compensation for delay to be paid under this condition shall not exceed 10% of accepted tender value of the work or the accepted tender value of the sectional part of the work as mentioned should be left for which a separate period of completion is possibly given. Means compensation under this clause shall not be more than 10% of the accepted tender value. Hello.
PPT नहीं appropriate है.
Sir, sir, please, sir. Quantum of damage कैसे निकालेंगे sir?
For what purpose your infrastructure is going on? आपने किस लिए बनाया इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर?
जैसे कोई ऑफिस बिल्डिंग है किसी
ठीक है ऑफिस बिल्डिंग उसने एक महीने लेट की
जी.
You cannot occupy that building for 1 month.
Yes sir.
आपको देखना है मैं अगर एक महीने के लिए मैं बिल्डिंग लेता हूं तो मैं कितना खर्चा मुझे करना है, मुझे आने जाने में कितना खर्चा होगा, वो ऑफिस से जहां ऑफिस से वो जगह मुझे मिली है वो कितनी दूर है जी. मेरे ओवरहेड एक्सपेंडिचर कितने होंगे. Well, it should be reasonable. It cannot be bugged out exact, but it should be reasonable so that it may be arbitrated in a, it should be arbitrable in arbitration case or should be defended in court. Some reasonable amount should be there on basis of some data.
Okay.
Office space aapko kiraye pe kitne par milega, office se kitna dur hai, overhead expenditure kitne ho rahe hain, you calculate accordingly.
नहीं, बहुत सारे ऐसे भी वर्क होंगे जिसमें कि उसका कोई डैमेज नहीं फील होता हो.
जैसे कोई बताइए मुझे.
हेलो सर.
वर्क है, डेवलपमेंट का वर्क है, बिल्डिंग पूरा रेडी है, सब कुछ चालू है, उसके बाहर में थोड़ा डेवलप करना है, मिट्टी और भरना है, ये सब काम
वो नहीं करना. तो मिट्टी पर आएगी तो मुझे कितना अधिक खर्च करना पड़ेगा. रोड खराब है तो मेरे आने जाने में कितना खर्चा हो रहा है.
तो
एसेस
कैसे करेंगे सर, ये चीज बोल रहे हैं, इसको एसेस कैसे करेंगे यदि वो
अप्रोक्सीमेट डाटा के बेस पर.
वो तो फिर क्लेम करेगा एजेंसी जो नहीं
ये डेलिब्रेशन के अंदर है, ये अभी डिसाइड हुआ नहीं है, डेलिब्रेशन में है, कंफ्यूजन है इसमें. बट जब तक कुछ नहीं है जब तक तो यू हैव टू वर्क एज पर प्रोविजंस ऑफ दिस सब क्लॉज ओनली.
ओके सर. ओके सर.
नाउ द ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ एग्जीक्यूटिव इंजीनियर. हां
सर.
हेलो
सर, जैसे ये क्लॉज में कहता है कि अगर वर्क
बोलिए. यस प्लीज.
सर
हेलो बोलिए.
हेलो.
हाँ
सर, इसमें क्लॉज 2 में ये कह रहा है कि अगर प्रोग्रेस बिलो है एज स्पेसिफाइड इन क्लॉज 5 तब भी हम इसको एक्सरसाइज कर सकते हैं.
यस, लेना चाहिए एक्शन. हम जो गलती करते हैं जो ड्यूरिंग करेंसी ऑफ द वर्क एक्शन नहीं लेते हैं वहां गलती करते हैं.
नहीं सर, एजेंसी इसको बाद में ऐसे नहीं कह सकता ये तो मतलब जब आर्बिट्रेशन में जाता है कि वो बाद में इसको कंपनसेट कर सकते थे, मतलब कि वो बाद में लेबर और मटेरियल लगाकर प्रोपोर्शनेटली कर सकते थे, हम विदहेल्ड तो कर ही रहे हैं उसका माइलस्टोन, तो इसको सर एक्शन कैसे लेंगे, मतलब इसका कुछ है सर, कुछ एग्जांपल है क्या कि इसका एक्शन ले सकते हैं हम अंडर क्लॉज 2? अगर फाइनेंशियल क्रंच की वजह से सर, अभी आजकल कोविड सिचुएशन में हम वैसे गवर्नमेंट रिलीज कर रहे हैं सारे जितने भी ऑब्लिगेशन है उसके, अभी हम उसको अगर फर्दर 1% के रेट पे और लगा देते हैं तो वो ये चीज कंटेस्ट कर सकता है कि अभी मैं ऑलरेडी फाइनेंशियल क्रंच में हूँ, आप मुझे और पेनल्टी लगाकर कॉम्पनसेशन लगाकर मेरे को और ये चीज कर रहे हो, तो उसका काम और स्लो हो सकता है इस चीज में।
गवर्नमेंट ने इस बारे में इकोनॉमिकल स्लो डाउन की वजह से या इस वजह से अभी तक कोई भी क्लॉजेस में कोई भी चेंज नहीं किया है, जिसमें चेंज किया परफॉर्म गारंटी में अननेच मनी आज के दिन में नहीं देनी है, लेकिन इस केस में अभी ऐसा कोई प्रोविजन इसमें रिलैक्सेशन कुछ नहीं किया है। एज पर रूल जैसे ही प्रोग्रेस इज बिलो द एज पर माइलस्टोन यू हैव टू रिकवर द कंपनसेशन, क्लियरली मेंशन, एंड ही कैन रिक्वेस्ट द सुपरिटेंडिंग इंजीनियर अकॉर्डिंगली कि भाई मेरे साथ ये ठीक नहीं हो रहा है, बट यू शुड ओनली रिकवर इन केस डिले इज अनजस्टिफाइड, डिले इज नॉट जस्टिफाइड। If hindrance is on the part of the contractor, you are not allowed sanctioning the extra item, this extension of time, then you have to think ki bhai main recover karu ki nahi karu, but clause says as per clause it has to be recovered if the progress is less than the specified progress.
सर मतलब सिर्फ माइलस्टोन विदहेल्ड नहीं करना है, उसके साथ साथ क्लॉज 2 में भी एक्शन लेना है।
यस सर,
थैंक यू
सर। दे वी आर, आपकी आवाज के लिए नहीं आ रही, थोड़ा ठीक से बोल रहे हैं।
You can shift milestones.
Hello. आवाज के लिए नहीं आ रही आपकी, माइक थोड़ा सा वॉल्यूम कम करें अपना। हेलो, हाँ हाँ बोला, बोलिए। माइलस्टोन, यस सर, यू सी whether the delay is on the part of the contractor or part of the department, kiske part par hai, the milestone withheld, the milestone withheld will be released subsequently as soon as he attained the milestone, second milestone agar attain kar leta hai to first ka release ho jayega usko, और उस स्टेज में आपको ये भी देखना है।
एक्चुअली withheld इज समथिंग यू कैन रिलीज आफ्टरवर्ड्स, बट इफ यू सेटल इट एज कंपनसेशन ऑफ डिले, इट्स अ सॉर्ट ऑफ रिकवरी यू आर मेकिंग, तो दोनों में ये फर्क है, इसलिए हम ओके जी, इसलिए हम जो withheld करते हैं दैट इज डिफरेंट थिंग, बट इफ यू वांट टू सेटल द केस एज कंपनसेशन फॉर डिले then only you should go for this clause,
but there is provision in this clause the superintendent, he can request the superintendent engineer that the levy is being made unauthorized, the SE can stop it or waive off under clause 2 only.
Yeah, so this is the basic difference actually.
Yeah, one more question sir. Actually, for non-achieving the milestone, 1% withheld is provision is there, sir. Is there any power to TS approving authority? But he can reduce to 0.5% or 0.25% due to this conditions, COVID conditions and all. Is there any such provision? TS authority can reduce that 1% to 0.5% like that?
Not at all. At the time of preparing
an NIT. 1% is 1%. No, sir. Now, actually, in the tender, it is 1%. 1% for non-achieving of the milestone 1.
Milestone, yes.
So the contractor has requested and he has given in writing to the TS authority. 0.5% you can consider due to this financial conditions of the COVID. Whether this TS authority can consider his request or a proposal can be moved by the AE or XN, please explain, sir.
As per this contract provisions, as per contract act, it is not possible. Only the authority, in this case, only DG is the authority to change the provisions of the original clause in GCC. वो प्रोविजन एनआईटी बनाते हुए तो वो कर सकता है, एनआईटी का अथॉरिटी कुछ भी कर सकता है, टेंडर होने के बाद नहीं कर सकता, फिर डीजी को अथॉरिटी है बस.
सर एक्सक्यूज मी सर.
हेलो
हेलो हेलो सर, मेरा एक क्वेश्चन था. जैसे हमने माइलस्टोन, फर्स्ट माइलस्टोन कॉन्ट्रैक्टर एजेंसी ने नहीं अचीव किया और हमने कंपनसेशन फॉर डिले कर दिया जो आप 1% के हिसाब से, और बाद में उसने माइलस्टोन, सेकंड माइलस्टोन अचीव कर दिया, तो वो रिकवरी का फिर हम कैसे करेंगे?
रिलीज करना है
उसे, आपने लेबी भी
रिलीज बोथ द माइलस्टोन,
लेबी कंपनसेशन कर चुके हैं पहले.
अगर हमने फर्स्ट माइलस्टोन पे अगर उसने नहीं अचीव किया और हमने रिकवरी कर दी, लेबी और कंपनसेशन लगा दिया, और उसने सेकंड माइलस्टोन अचीव कर दिया, तब उस केस में
लेकिन माइल स्टोन का अचीव किया, माइल स्टोन का पैसा वापस हो जाएगा. बट यू हैव टू फर्स्ट सी वेदर द डिले वाज ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रैक्टर और पार्ट ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट. इफ इट इज पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रैक्टर मीन्स डिले उसके पार्ट पर है, ले भी उसको लगनी है उस पीरियड की.
हेलो
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 सर, माइलस्टोन में जो टारगेट दिया रहता है, क्या उसे हम लोग बीच कॉन्ट्रैक्ट पीरियड में चेंज कर सकते हैं?
कंसीडरिंग द साइड कंडीशंस, यस कर सकते हैं. बट अमाउंट क्वांटम के 1% को आधा कर वो नहीं कर सकते.
नहीं अमाउंट नहीं सर, जो इसमें टारगेट दे रखा हम लोगों ने, सपोज 4 माइलस्टोन, तो उसको हम लोग आगे पीछे कर सकते हैं, फर्स्ट वाला सेकंड में, सेकंड वाला फर्स्ट में.
दिस इज द प्रोविजंस ऑफ क्लॉज 5 इटसेल्फ, 5 कर सकते हैं. इट इज माइलस्टोन इंजीनियरिंग चार्ज.
तो इसकी कंपिटेंट अथॉरिटी इंजीनियरिंग चार्ज है कि टीएस अथॉरिटी?
इंजीनियरिंग चार्ज.
हेलो
हेलो
हेलो सर,
हेलो,
वन क्वेश्चन सर. देयर आर 4 माइलस्टोन्स. There are 4 milestones in the agreement, sir. Can we reschedule it to 6 milestones?
That's a yes, thing. Of course.
But one question, sir.
Keep in mind only one thing. What is the stipulated period? What period you are extending? That extended period is delayed by the only part of the contractor or part of the department, or it is reasonable delay. If it is reasonable delay, you can do. If it is not reasonable, then you can change the milestone from 4 to 2, 6 to 4, but within that stipulated period only. You can adjust them.
Hello.
Can it be unilateral?
Sir, one question.
Many cases, it is generally found that the CE is issued notice or take action under clause 2 after 6 or more than 1 year of the completion of the agreement, as per it. But the whether notice is valid or invalid, sir?
आप लोगों की आवाज नहीं क्लियर सुनाई, थोड़ा ठीक से क्लियर बोले
जरा. अच्छा सर, मेनी टाइम्स इट इज जनरली फाउंड दैट द सी इज इशूड नोटिस और टेक एक्शन अंडर क्लॉज 2 आफ्टर 6 और मोर देन 1 ईयर ऑफ कंप्लीशन ऑफ द एग्रीमेंट, देन द नोटिस और एक्शन टेकन बाय सी इज वैलिड और नॉट?
इट इज 100% इनवैलिड.
हां सर,
इट इज 100% इनवैलिड.
जनरली इट इज जनरली फाउंड सर, मोस्ट ऑफ द सी बट सी can take action under clause 2 more than 1 year, 6 months, but we are facing arbitration on that ground.
नहीं, अभी आपने GCC नया वाला GCC आप सबने पढ़ा है क्या? GCC नया वाला ये जो नया वाला जीसीसी है हर ऑफिसर की इसमें ड्यूटी इन्होंने फिक्स कर दी है।
अच्छा।
अगर आप कोई भी एक्शन उस स्टिपुलेटेड टाइम के बाहर लेंगे तो आपका एक्शन इनवैलिड होगा। अगर उसने कोई एक्स्ट्रा आइटम आपको दी है और आपने उसका जवाब नहीं दे रहे हैं तो जो उसने एक्स्ट्रा आइटम का रेट दिया है वो एप्लीकेबल होगा। अगर आपने उसका स्टिपुलेटेड पीरियड के अंदर 45 डेज आजकल आपके पास टाइम, अगर उसमें आपने टाइम नहीं दिया, जवाब नहीं दिया, तो व्हाटएवर रेट इज प्रपोज्ड बाय द कॉन्ट्रैक्टर इट विल बी द फाइनल रेट। और जो पहले था कि वो ऐसी चीफ इंजीनियर डीजी एडीजी रखे रहते थे, अब हरेक के पास टाइम फिक्स टाइम है। यू हैव टू टेक द एक्शन विद इन द वेल स्टिपुलेटेड एज पर प्रोविजंस ऑफ द क्लॉजेस। दिस क्लॉज 2 और द रिसेंटली क्लॉज 12 एंड क्लॉज 25 हैज बीन मॉडिफाइड टू सच एन एक्सटेंट। अगर आपने एक्शन जिस अथॉरिटी ने भी एक्शन नहीं लिया, डिपार्टमेंट विल बी एट द लूजर पॉइंट। नाउ अवेट जीसीसी प्रोविजन ऑफ जीसीआर बोथ पे। अगर कॉन्ट्रैक्टर काम नहीं करेगा तो उस पर पेनल्टी है, आप नहीं काम करेंगे तो आप पे एक्शन होगा। इट इज बोथ वेज नाउ इट इज।
एक्सक्यूज मी सर,
अर्लियर एसी ने नहीं किया, चीफ ने नहीं किया, अब इसमें बहानेबाजी कुछ नहीं चलेगी। देयर इज नो एक्सक्यूज एट ऑल।
एक्सक्यूज मी सर, माय क्वेश्चन इज, हेलो सर, मेरा क्वेश्चन है, अगर डिले डिपार्टमेंट के पार्ट में है तो क्या कॉन्ट्रैक्टर कंपेंसेशन क्लेम कर सकता है?
बिल्डिंग्स
अगर डिले डिपार्टमेंट के कारण है तो क्या कॉन्ट्रैक्टर कंपेंसेशन मांग सकता है?
अगर यस ऑफ कोर्स, व्हाई नॉट
सर, मांगता ही है, उसी में तो आर्बिट्रेशन में जाता है कि हमारा इतना
ये जो क्लोजेज का ना आप थोड़ा, क्योंकि ये 41 क्लोजेज है तीनों का, तो ये पहले एक दिन का कोर्स था, मैंने डेढ़ दिन में कराया। ऐसे करेंगे तो चार क्लोज भी नहीं होंगे लंच से पहले, तो ऐसे कर लेते हैं आप एक घंटा इसके लिए क्वेश्चन आंसर के लिए रखेंगे। टोटल अमाउंट ऑफ कंपनसेशन फॉर डिले टू बी पेड अंडर दिस क्लॉज शैल नॉट एक्सीड 10% ऑफ एक्सेप्टेड नेट वैल्यू। In case no compensation has been decided during the progress of the work, this shall not be waiver of right to levy compensation by the said authority if the work remains incomplete on final justified action date of the completion. Whether action has been taken during the currency of the work or it is taken by the after completion of the work, the action under clause 2 is valid. If BNC decide to give further extension of time following performance of the work beyond the justified action date, the contractor shall be liable to pay compensation for such extended period. The hindrance under clause 5.5 comes for this sub-clause. ENC decided the further extension of time allowing performance the work beyond justified extended date, the contractor shall be liable to pay compensation for such extended period. And for this, mutual consent should be there. If contractor is not given writing to accept this extended date and he is going on work silently, means his consent is there, then you have to write to contractor that the period of the work has been extended up to such and such period, but for this period itne to itne you will be levied compensated at the rate such and such as per provisions of the clause 2 of the contract. If any variation amount of contract takes place during such extended period, means for the hindrance of clause 5.5, and the contractor becomes entitled to additional time under clause 12, jitna extended time isme milega par extra work done hoga clause 12 se jo milna chahiye wo us period ka us par levy compensation nahi hoga. However, during further extended period beyond justified extended period and delay occurs by events under clause 5.2 means natural calamity, the contractor shall be liable to pay compensation for such delay. Means after justified period, after justified extended period, work remains incomplete and the engineer in charge has extended the time under clause 5.5, means levy will be compensation will be levied for that period if the contractor complete the work within that extended period. If any hindrance which comes under category of 5.2 means force majeure, unable circumstance, lockout, etc., even then the contractor shall be liable to pay compensation for such delay, provided that compensation due to the progress of work before the justified extended date of completion is for delay under this clause shall be for non-achievement of sectional completion or part handing over of work on stipulated justified date for such part, or if delay affects any other work or service. This is without prejudice to the right of action by the in charge under clause 3.4, delay in performance and claim of compensation under this clause. Means if the work is delayed, you can take action under clause 2 as well as you can take action under clause 3 also. In case of under clause 2 has not been finalized and the work has been determined under clause 3, work has been determined, the right of action under this clause shall remain post determination of the contract, but levy of compensation shall be days the progress is behind the schedule on the date of determination as assessed by the authority in schedule F after due consideration of justified extension. Justified extension plus any hindrance under clause 5.5, when the work is completed, extension will be granted with levy or without levy considering date of determination. For compensation of delay, if not decided before the determination of the contract, shall be decided after determination of the contract also. In case contractor did not achieve a particular milestone or rescheduled milestone, the amount shown against that milestone shall be withheld to be adjusted against the compensation levied as above. In case the contractor does not achieve a particular milestone or rescheduled milestone, the amount shown against the milestone shall be withheld to be adjusted against the compensation levied as above. If compensation levy has already been levied and amount for not achieving milestone has been withheld, that levy compensation will be adjusted against this withheld amount. Withholding of this amount on failure of to achieve a milestone shall be automatic without any notice to the contractor. In this case, you need not to give any notice for withholding amount to the contractor, as it is already in your contract provisions that when contractor will not be achieved this milestone by such and such date, such and such amount will be withheld. However, if the contractor catches the progress work on the subsequent milestone, the withheld amount shall be released. No interest whatsoever shall be payable on such withheld amount. Now, the compensation for delay for maintenance work. All provisions under this clause are same as provisions of construction works, EPC project, as mentioned above, except the following, means compensation of delay of the work. With maximum rate of 1% per month of delay to be computed on per day basis, based on damage suffered due to stated delay on the part of the contractor, if scheduled completion of work is more than 1 year. In case of stipulated period more than 1 year, 1%. If stipulated period is 6 months to 1 year, it is 1% to 2%. If the period stipulated period for work is up to 6 months, the levy compensation is up to 2 to 5%, subject to the damage suffered due to stated delay on the part of the contractor. Now, clause 2A for maintenance by estimated cost up to 25 lakhs. The other clause for 40 bucks for the maintenance works more than 25 lakhs, and this clause is applicable for the work up to estimated cost is up to 25 lakhs. If the contractor fails to maintain the required progress to complete the work and clear the site on before the contact period, Contact period mean stipulated date of completion without prejudice to any right or remedy available under the law to the government on account of such breach, pay as compensation the amount calculated at the date stipulated below, at the authority specified stipulated may decide on the amount of accepted tender value of work every complete day or month as determined that the work remains incomplete in the following manner. If there is no hindrance, compensation shall be levied if work is incomplete, if there is no hindrance at all. If site is not available, there will be no compensation in case of maintenance works up to 25 lakhs. If there is a partial hindrance, then engineer in charge will compare amount of work executed in available hindrance-free time with respect to total time and total work. Compensation will be levied if actual work executed is less than as a calculated pro rata basis. Means if hindrance-free time is 70% and work should be completed 70%, if work is completed 70%, there will be no levy compensation. If work is 65%, then levy compensation will be there. If there is a hindrance, no compensation will be there. And in case of 225 lakhs, the most important is time is essence of the contract. Means whatever stipulated time is there, contractor has to complete the work within the targeted period. There is no extension of time. And if there is a hindrance, there will be no levy compensation. Hello.
Sir, continue. Slide.
Yes, sir.
Sir, continue. Hello.
Yes, sir. Continue, kariye, sir.
For compensable delay for up to 25 lakh with maximum same rate of 1% delay computed per day basis. If the stipulated period is more than 1 year, 1 to 2%, 6 months to 12 months, and it is 2 to 5% if the period is up to 6 months. Nobody always that the total amount of compensation for delay to be paid under this country shall not exceed 10% of the accepted tender value. In case no compensation has been decided during the authority by the authority institute lab during the progress of the work, this shall be no waiver of the right to levy compensation by the said authority incomplete on stipulated date of the completion. This is without prejudice to the right of action by the NINCHA under clause 3-4 delay in performance and claim of the compensation under that clause. In case action under clause 2 has not been finalized and the work has been determined under clause 3, the right of action under this clause shall remain post determination of the contract, but levy or compensation shall be for days the work is behind the schedule on date of determination as assessed by the authority. The compensation for delay, if not decided before determination contract, shall be decided after determination of the contract. The amount of compensation may be adjusted or set off against any sum payable to the contractor under this or any other contract with the government. Now we come on clause 3 for construction bus when contract can be determined. Subject to the other provisions contained in this clause, the engineer in charge without prejudice to any other right or remedy against the contractor in respect of any delay, safety norms, inferior workmanship, any claim of damages and or any other provisions of the contract or otherwise, and whether the date of completion has or has not elapsed, by notice in writing as to absolutely determine the contract in any of the following cases. 1. If the contractor, having been given notice to rectify, to reconstruct or replace any defective work or work being performed in inefficient, improper or unworkmanlike manner and omit to comply the requirement of notice for a period of 7 days thereafter. This is clause 3.1. 3.1 says if work is being constructor, there is defects or work being performed inefficient. Inefficient manner means not constructed properly, or workmanlike means workmanship is not good, or omit the but a notice is given and he is not complying the requirement of the notice after 7 days also, then you can determine the contact. Two, if the contact has without reasonable cause suspended the progress of the work, if contact suspend the progress of work without any reason or fail to proceed with the work with due diligence. Due diligence means to execute the work with full effort matching with our milestone fix. It is called due diligence, and continue to do so after notice in writing for 7 days from the engineering chair. If you have given the notice that you have suspended the work without any reason, or you are not doing the work with due diligence, and giving of this notice, and after the 7 days also he is not taking action, then you can determine the work under sub clause 3.2. Three, if the contractor fails to complete the work or section of work with individual date of completion on or before the supplier justified extended date on or before such date of completion, the engineer in charge without any prejudice to any other right or remedy under any other provision in the contract has been reasonable time in a notice given in writing in that behalf as either manually agreed or in absence of such mutual agreement by his own assessment making such time essence of the contract, and then in the opinion of engineering charge, the contractor will be unable to complete the same or does not complete the same within the period specified. Means if the progress is not as per terms of 5.5 or the contractor is not positioned to complete the work within the justified extended date, or further he is not in position to complete the work further extended under clause 5.5, then you have to give the notice that you have not complete work will be not completed. Yeah, you will be not be completed to complete the work as per extended date considering the ground situation. At present there is such and such only progress, you have to complete such and such work, then action is being will be taken under sub clause 3.3. Then 4, if the contractor persistently neglect to carry out his obligation under the contract and does not remedy it or take effective step to remedy it within 7 days after notice. If the contractor neglects obligation means he has to work within the targeted period, applying safety norms, applying such as a TNP, and you have given notice and he is not obeying your restrictions, then you can take the action under this clause 3.4. 3.5, if the contractor offer or agree to give any government employee or to any other person on behalf any gift or consideration of any kind, if the contractor shall enter into an agreement with government in connection with which commission has been paid, if it came to your notice to the engineering charge, then work can be resigned. If the contractor has secured the contract with government as a result of wrong tendering or other bona fide methods, other non-bona fide methods, complete tendering and commit breach of the integrity agreement. If the contractor urges insolvent or having a receiving order or order for administration of estate made against him. If the contractor being a company shall pass a resolution or court shall made an order for bind up. Company reorganize karta hai ya court us company ko bind up kar deta hai. Then you can take action in clause 3.9. If the contractor sells apparel and education being labeled only goods and allowed to be continued for a period of 3 weeks, then you can take action across this 3.10. If the contractor assigned excluding part of work assigned to other agency by the contract, as per terms of contract, transfers, sublet, then you can take action under this clause. Subletting any work given to any contractor on labor rate and material, those materials which are not being used in my original work is not called subletting of the work. Means the work can be given on piece work on labor rate by the contractor. It doesn't come in the category of the subletting of the work.
28 days तो समझ नहीं आता है। हेलो 28 days तो समझ नहीं आता है। 21 days ये सर 28 days जो सफर है ये साला
लेट क्यों करना है उसको मैं समझ में आया नहीं। जोर से बोलिए जरा, क्लियर आवाज नहीं आ रही आपकी।
This is being levied on his goods and allowed it to be continued for a period of 28 days. Sound नहीं आता है। क्या है?
सर साउंड में बहुत ज्यादा इको है, कुछ भी समझ नहीं आ रहा।
हेलो
के मिश्रा जी,
हेलो साउंड में बहुत ज्यादा इको है।
के मिश्रा जी हैं क्या? हेलो
जी, अब कुछ ठीक है?
के मिश्रा जी,
जी जी
भैया, इसका आवाज का थोड़ा कुछ करो, मुझे भी बहुत दिक्कत हो रही है आज सुनने में इनके।
बहुत इको है। लोग सर
माइक चालू कर, इसे बंद कर देते हैं, म्यूट डाल कर देते हैं सर।
भाई जो बोल रहा है उसको ही बाकी का मूट होना चाहिए, इसलिए प्रॉब्लम हो रही है।
जी जी, जी।
हाँ बोलिए आप।
यस सर।
हाँ बोलिए, पूछ रहे थे कुछ, पूछिए। आज
पेनाल्टी है ना 28 days की सर।
हेलो
सर, 310 को एक बार एक्सप्लेन करें।
310 को?
यस सर।
इफ द कॉन्ट्रैक्टर सेल्स सबलेट एजुकेशन,
हां
इफ द कॉन्ट्रैक्टर सेल्स सबलेट एजुकेशन बीइंग लेबिड ऑन हिज गुड्स एंड अलाउड इज टू बी कंडक्ट फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 21 डे, इफ गवर्नमेंट इज डिक्लेयरिंग द फर्म इनसॉल्वेंट ड्यू टू एनी रीजन, एजुकेशन इज बीइंग मेड मींस his material, his property is being taken over by the government, it is called execution, and it is allowed for 3 weeks. Up to 3 weeks you cannot take action under this clause. If it is beyond 21 days 3 weeks, then you can determine the work under this sub clause. Hello,
नहीं समझ आया सर, फिर से एक
नहीं समझ
आया। नहीं सर हिंदी में समझा।
अगर ठेकेदार से कोई रिकवरी हो रही है और वो लगातार 3 हफ्ते तक हो रही है, जारी हो, कोई स्टेट ऑफिस कर रही है, कोई कंपनी कर रही है, तो उसके ठेके को आप 3 हफ्ते के बाद उसको डिटरमिन कर सकते हैं।
ओके सर, ओके, थैंक्स थैंक्स।
एक्सक्यूज मी सर,
हाँ
ये डिटरमिन कर सकते हैं, ऑप्शनल है कि मैंडेटरी हो जाएगा, क्योंकि गवर्नमेंट का एग्जीक्यूशन है वो,
लेवी गवर्नमेंट का एग्जीक्यूशन है, मतलब अब आप देख रहे हैं कि उसकी फाइनेंशियल कंडीशन ऐसी नहीं है वर्क को गो ऑन कर सके, इट इज बेटर फॉर यू टू डिटरमाइन दी वर्क।
सर मान लिया वो वर्क को ठीक कर रहा है, इज इट ऑप्शनल और मैंडेटरी टू फॉलो
By conditions दे रखी है ना, अगर ये conditions fulfill करता है तो आपको determine करना है।
नहीं ये तो then it is mandatory।
Hello,
it is mandatory।
Yes it is provision, it is mandatory, yes।
It is mandatory।
But मतलब you are supposing only कि अगर उसका execution कोई government agency execution कर रही है, तो we cannot suppose कि he is doing the work very properly।
नहीं If the condition, मतलब केस हो सकता है सर कि वो अपना वर्क ठीक से कर रहा है।
Mandatory, yes, mandatory, मतलब yes. Provision is there, you can take action.
Can, yes, should.
Excuse me, sir.
Hello,
Sir, यदि किसी सर यदि किसी कॉन्ट्रैक्टर के पास 4 वर्क है सर और एक में उसका एजुकेशन होता है, तो क्या तीनों वर्क को हमें डिटरमिन करना पड़ेगा?
ये वर्क का एजुकेशन नहीं है। हाँ हाँ, वो तो पर्टिकुलर इंजीनियरिंग चार्ज को सोचना है, अगर आपके पास चारों काम है तो चारों करने हैं आपको।
यदि ये मैंडेटरी है तब तो ये हमारे पास में ऑप्शन नहीं है, इसके अलावा उसको साथ
मैंडेटरी यस शैल बट कहीं यूज नहीं लिख रहा, कहीं नहीं है,
इसका मतलब सर कि यदि किसी कॉन्ट्रैक्टर के पास 10 वर्क है, एक वर्क में यदि उसे ये होता है एजुकेशन, तो बाकी 9 वर्क
नहीं है, ये उसका एग्जीक्यूशन है, वर्क का नहीं है, उसके गुड्स पर, उसके सामान का है।
हाँ हाँ, किसी वर्क में वो यदि लेबल हुआ पेनाल्टी के लिए, अगर वर्क
नहीं, नहीं आप कंफ्यूज हो रहे हैं, ये एजेंसी का, एजेंसी का एग्जीक्यूशन होगा, एजेंसी पर वो लेवी आएगा गवर्नमेंट से, उसके गुड्स पे नहीं आना है, वो नंबर ऑफ वर्क से इसका मतलब ही नहीं है। अगर एक एजेंसी पर गवर्नमेंट की कोई लायबिलिटी है उसके गुड्स और उस पे, तो उसके सारे वर्क्स पे रिकवरी जाएगी, तो उसका ये मैंडेटरी है कि आफ्टर 21 डेज यू हैव टू
रिटर्न। रिकवरी जाएगी तो वो ठीक है, वो पे करेगा, बट वर्क डिटरमिन करना होगा ना फिर इस केस में।
हाँ, तो ये वही मैं पूछ रहा हूँ, इज इट मैंडेटरी? तो सर इस
सेम ऑप्शन होना चाहिए, ये तो ऑप्शन होना चाहिए।
एग्जीक्यूशन 3 वीक्स तक चल रहा है, यहाँ ये पहली कंडीशन है, वो रिकवरी फ्लोट होना और वो सस्पेंड होना इज अ डिफरेंट थिंग। यहाँ हो रहा है कि एग्जीक्यूशन 21 डेज तक कंटिन्यू है,
इफ एग्जीक्यूशन कंटिन्यूज टिल 21 डेज
मतलब वो देख रहा हूं कोई ऑप्शन है,
इट शैल बी मैंडेटरी और ऑप्शनल।
आपस में बात ना करें, आपस में बात ना करें। हेलो In above mentioned subclause, when the contractor has made himself liable for action under any of the cases aforesaid, the engineer in charge on behalf of President of India shall have powers A to determine the contract as aforesaid, as so far as performance of the work by the contractor is concerned, means of a determination notice in writing to the contractor and under the hand of engineer in charge shall be conclusive evidence upon such determination. The unless money deposit, the security deposit already recovered, payable, and performance guarantee under the contract shall be liable to be forfeited and shall be absolutely at the disposal of the government. After giving notice to the contractor to measure up the work of the contractor and to take such whole or part or the balance or part thereof as shall be unexecuted out of his hands and to give it to the another contractor to complete the work, the contractor whose contract is determined as above shall not be allowed to participate in the tendering process for the balance work. Whatever work is has been executed as per specifications, it will be paid to the contractor, and which work is executed but is not as per specification, it will not be measured. And when notice has been given to the contractor to measure up the work, if he is not attending the site, the measurement taken by the engineer in charge shall be final and be binding on the contractor. Under clause 2, take action under clause 3, you should be very, very cautious. Your action, you should take a system rule-wise, means you have to first giving, you have to issue the notice to the contractor and the so-called notice. What will you write in clause so-called notice? You will write that the what is the reason of determination, means sub-clause 3.1.2.11. You have to mention particularly ye clause hai, and I am taking, we want to take action under this sub-clause. You have to give so-called notice, and this so-called notice should be approved by the NIT approving authority. He will issue the so-called notice that, and it should be approved by the this technical sanction authority. Engineering charge will issue, and notice will show the action is being proposed under such clause. You are hereby given the time such and such to so-called. Why not action may be taken against you under this sub-clause. You have to mention this sub-clause, particularly sub-clause under which you want to take action. And on receiving the reply of the contractor, you will scrutinize and you will see whether the reason given the contractor by the contractor are reasonable or not. If it is not reasonable, then the further notice will be issued with the determination with the approval of the final, it is called final notice, and will be issued with the approval of the technical sanction authority. And it should be issued by the engineer in charge. You should be very, very particular when you take action under clause 2 and clause 3, and whenever you give a notice under clause 2 or clause 3, your actions to reach to finality. Finality means if you are taken under clause 2, you have given notice under clause 2, work is progress is not as per terms of 5.5, and the action will be taken, his reply should come. On that reply, you have to see whether the reply given to the contractor is reasonable or not. If it's not reasonable, then you issue the notice, and under clause 2, the notice are to be issued under the signature of the superintending engineer. Means levy taking levying authority, levy compensation authority will issue the notice. Under clause 3, the notice should be approved by the technical sanction authority. So-called notice should be in time, and as per section 55 of Contract Act 1872, to take action under clause 3, your contract should be alive. Means time should be essence of the contract at the time of determination. So you should be very, very cautious when taking action clause and 2 and 3. The action should be taken very rarely. In case the contract is not positioned to complete the work within target period, the action under clause 2 and clause 3 should be taken very, very early stage. Now it is 11:20, 30 minute tea break. Hello?
Yes, sir.
We will meet at 11:45. Now ask a question from clause 3. What is the doubt under clause 3? Hello?
Hello, sir.
ये
जो ईपीसी कॉन्ट्रैक्ट पे ये इनके कॉन्ट्रैक्चुअल ऑब्लिगेशंस क्या क्या है, थोड़ा सा इसको ब्रीफ कीजिएगा.
ईपीसी का?
हाँ हाँ हाँ, आपने तो ये लिखा है एज पर कॉन्ट्रेक्चुअल फॉर द कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड मेंटेनेंस वर्क एट ईपीसी में द कॉन्ट्रेक्चुअल मतलब सर ये तो जीसीसी किताब में सब कुछ है, लेकिन ये कॉन्ट्रैक्ट जो बुलेट्स है ना जिसमें कॉन्ट्रेक्चुअल ऑब्लिगेशन क्या क्या है ईपीसी मोड पे, ये बताइएगा थोड़ा सा, क्योंकि आप तो काफी पुराने हैं, हम आपको जानते हैं सर.
समझ रहा हूँ बात को.
वो ये जो ईपीसी मोड का जो ए है, इस ईपीसी लमसम जो ये चल रहा है, तो इसके कॉन्ट्रैक्चुअल ऑब्लिगेशंस क्या क्या है, मतलब कॉन्ट्रैक्टर कहाँ कहाँ हमको सेफ पैसे से निकल जाते हैं, तो उसको कैसे आइडेंटिफाई करें.
तो ये जो मैनुअल प्रोविजंस का जो होगा लेक्चर, उसके साथ इसे टेकअप करूंगा मैं.
अच्छा ठीक है ठीक है, थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू.
उसमें टेकअप करें.
ओके ओके.
Now, we come on clause 3A, construction works. This is also a clause, very important clause. You have to be very cautious. When the tender rates are very low, then you have to take, you will be very cautious that the record should be handed over to the contractor within the targeted period. Otherwise, the contractor will run away. So, under this clause, clause 3A, what is clause 3A? In case work cannot be started due to reasons not within the control of the contractor, means delay is on the part of the department, within 1/8 the stipulated time of completion of the work or 1 month, whichever is higher, 1 mahina ya stipulated period ka 8 mahina, jo bhi zyada hai uske andar agar kaam nahi shuru ho sakta any reason, but it is not on the part of the contractor, then either party may close the contractor by giving notice to the other party stating the reasons. In such eventuality, the performer guarantee of the contractor will be refunded within following time limit. Up to 1 crore should be refunded within 15 days, 1 crore to 10 crore within 21 days, and if the tender value of the exceeded rupees 10 crore, then it should be returned within 30 days. This clause, neither party can claim any compensation of such eventuality. This clause is not applicable for any breach of the contract by either party. When the rates are on lower side, the contractor will try to avoid the contract. Hence, you have to hand over the site or required documents are to be provided within 1 month so that the delay should not be on the part of the department. Otherwise, the contractor will run away. But this is safeguard, very safeguard for you. If the site is not available within 1 month, if you want to close the work, you can close the work under this clause 3A. Or if you are not handing the record within this period, 1 month or 1/8 of the stipulated period, contractor will run away. This clause is not any breach of the contract, and there will be no compensation, and no party can claim the compensation. For EPC also, the provision says, provider accept only, PG is to be refunded within 30 days, and for maintenance work, the PG is refunded to 15 days. As far as you are saying, the contractor will run away in EPC contract, etc., under clause 2 and under clause 3, you have to keep in mind only the notice. Proper notice should be given in time. What is the proper notice? Under clause 2, it should be given under the signature of the superintendent engineers. Under clause 3, the notice should be approved by the technical sanction authority. And sufficient time should be given for show cause so that contractor should not say that you have taken action on one self side. अपने आप ही आपने ले लिया एंड टेकिंग एक्शन अंडर क्लॉज 3 एक्शन अंडर क्लॉज 5 12 एंड 15 व्हाट विल बी द एक्शन अंडर क्लॉज 5 एक्सटेंशन ऑफ टाइम व्हाट विल बी एक्शन अंडर क्लॉज 12 सैंक्शन ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा आइटम एक्सेट्रा क्लॉज 15 सैंक्शन ऑफ ईओटी ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ सस्पेंशन ऑफ वर्क These actions should be taken before taking action under clause 3 and the notice, proper notice should be issued. If you are not following rule or you are not proper notice means by the issue by approved by the competent authority, then your action will be
Sir.
Hello.
आवाज आ रही है
मुझे हाँ आ रही है आवाज आ रही
सर क्लॉज 3 में अगर हमने एक्शन लिया
जी
और डिपार्टमेंट ये आर्बिट्रेशन में हार जाती है केस तो क्या फ्यूचर में जो उसको प्रॉफिट होने वाला था वो उसको मिलेगा
नहीं मिलेगा ये आप आएंगे तो जो डिफरेंट क्लॉजेज आएगी उसमें क्लियरली लिखा हुआ है आपको एक्सटेंशन मिलेगा कंपनसेशन
कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एक्ट में तो ये दिया हुआ है कि फ्यूचर में जो भी उसका वो होता प्रॉफिट वो उसको मिलना चाहिए कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एक्ट जो हमारा कहता है कि फ्यूचर में जो उसको प्रॉफिट मिलना चाहिए वो उसको कंपनसेशन का तो उसको मिलना चाहिए
सर
सर पीपीटी नहीं लिखा है सर
हेलो
हाँ
आवाज गड़बड़ हो रहा है थोड़ा माइक सब खोल लेते ना जिसको पूछना वो माइक खोले तो कोई दिक्कत देर बिल भी नो डिस्टरबेंस सेट हो
सर मैं एस के शर्मा बोला पीपीटी नहीं दिखाई सर
पीपीटी नहीं दिखाई दे रही
हाँ सर
ये तो
मैं देख
रही
हूँ आपका नेटवर्क इश्यू होगा
एक है शर्मा जी
पीपीटी में दिखाई दे रही है
दिखाई दे रही है सर
दिख रही है दिख रही
है सर भी टाइप कर रहा है ऑलरेदी लिंक भी शेयर कर
दिख रही है
लिंक भी शेयर कर दिया गया है सर उसके लिए कोई बात
दिख रहा है सर
मेरा क्वेश्चन था
सबको दिखाई दे रहा है
दिख रहा है सर
नाउ दिस इज क्लॉज 4 दिस क्लॉज 4 इज सेफगार्ड इफ यू हैव नॉट टेकन एक्शन अंडर क्लॉज 3 इन एनी केस इन व्हिच एनी ऑफ द पावर्स कंफर्ड अपॉन The engineer in charge by clause 3 thereof shall have become exercisable and same are not exercised, the non-exercise thereof shall not constitute a waiver of any of the conditions hereof, and such power shall not withstanding be exercisable in the event of any future case of default by the contractor, and the liability of the contractor for compensation shall remain unaffected. As far as if you have not taken action under clause 3, under which circumstances you have not taken the action, means to take action under clause 3, you have to give proper notice under clause 3 with the approval of the technical sanction authority. If the circumstances were there to take action under clause 3, means there are 1 to 11 subparas under which you have to take action under clause 3, but you have not taken, then giving a notice under clause 4, you can take the action against the contractor as per provisions of the clause 3 of the contract. You can take over the material of the contractor, you can hire the machinery equipped at site, and you can execute the work by any means, and you accordingly you can take the action as per provisions of clause 3. And only it is superficial clause, but even if you will not take action under clause 3, you can take action under this clause. The provisions of EPC maintenance also same for construction works. Now very important clause comes clause 5. This clause 5 determines the direction of your action taken under clause 2 and clause 3. So you should know the provisions of clause 5 very, very distinctly. For construction work, the time allowed for execution of the work as specified in Schedule F or the extended time in accordance with these conditions shall be essence of the contract. The time should be essence of the contract means there should be a particular date, original stipulated date of completion. If you are giving any extension, further extension, you should give particular date. It's not to be given by month or by year. Work is hereby extended, date of extension granted up to 1 year or 1 month or 4 months earlier. You have to give the firm date, means you have to make the time essence of the contract. If you have not given the particular date or you have not made the essence of the contract, as per section 55 of Contract Act 1872, your action taken under clause 2 and clause 3 will be invalid. Hence, you have to make the time essence of the contract. Whatever time is given, it should be a particular, in case contractor is requesting for EOT, he has to submit for extension of time, he has to submit program according to program, and seeing the ground reality, you sanction the extension. And if the contractor is not going on with the work, you have to issue the notice as per the stage reached. If that stage is reached by the contractor, you have to issue the notice. And in any case, time, particular time, is to be made essence of the contract. The execution of work shall commence from such time period as mentioned should have from the date of handing over site, notified by the engineer or notified by the engineer, whichever is later. Schedule F mein kya date hogi? The date from 1 to 10 days from the letter of intent will be date of start. This date of start or handover of site, whichever is later, will be the date of the start. If the contract commits default in commencing the execution of work as aforesaid, means handing over of the site or date of site as mentioned in schedule of NIT paper, whichever is later, if contractor do not start the work, then the PG shall be forfeited by the in charge and shall be absolute at the discipline of government without prejudice to any other right or remedy available in the law. As soon as possible, but within 7 working days of award of work and in consideration of schedule of handing over site as specified in schedule F. In NIT papers, you have mentioned particularly regarding handing over the site, the such and such site will be handed over by parts or will be handed over in full by such and such period. So this schedule of handing over the site, and schedule of issue of design edge is specified in schedule F. The issue of schedule of design edge is specified, it should match with your milestone fixed in clause 5. The contractor submit a time and progress time of each milestone. Considering these two things, side of handover of the site and issue of design, the contractor will submit his program. The engineering charge within 7 working days, he has to submit seven working days of award of work, and after 7 working days after that, the engineering charge is required, if required, modified and communicate the program approved to the contractor, failing which the program submitted by the contractor shall be deemed to be approved by the engineering charge. If engineering charge not approved within 7 days working days, then program submitted by the contractor will be final. The program shall include all details, balance drawing and decisions required to complete the contract with specific dates by which these details are required by contractor without causing any delay in execution of the work. As per milestone fee, the contractor will request that such and such drawings, such and such decision required before that date, so that this will be details should be there in program so that the department may give decision in due time. In case of non-submission of construction program by the contractor, the program approved by the engineering charge shall be deemed to be final. The engineering charge will approve the program based on stipulated time fixed, milestone fixed. Accordingly, the program will be approved by the engineering charge. However, the approval of engineering charge of such program shall not relieve the contractor of any obligation under the contract, means However, in any way, the contractor has to complete the work within the targeted period, with quality, with specification as mentioned in contract documents. The contractor submit the time and progress chart and progress report using the mutually agreed software. It may be Primavera or MS Office or in other format decided by the engineering charge for the work done during previous month to the engineering charge on or before 5th day of the each month. Failing which, a recovery as per schedule F to be decided by the NIT approving authority shall be made on per week basis or part basis in case of delay in submission of the monthly progress report. Now we come on the hindrances. If the work is delayed by force majeure, means unavoidable circumstances, abnormally bad weather, serious loss or damage by fire or civil commotion, local commotion of workmen, strike or lockout affecting any of the days employed on the work. Civil commotion, local commotion, unrest in country, unrest in workmen, etc., lockout, strike, etc., delay on the part of other contractor or tradesmen engaged by the engineer in charge in executing work not forming part of the contract. If it's delay on the part of the other contractor who are doing the work at the site of the work but is not part of this contract, it delay also will come on the department. Any other cause like above, which in the region open, in the region open of the in charge beyond the contractor's control, then upon happening of any such event causing delay, the contractor shall immediately give notice thereof in writing to the engineering charge for anti-hindrance physical or behaviors as prescribed in schedule F, but shall nevertheless use constantly his best endeavor to prevent or make good the delay, and shall to do all that may be reasonably required to satisfy the engineering charge to proceed with the work. Means contractor will try to remove the hindrance, any hindrance which is nature calamity or on the part of the department will be allowed, but contractor should make his full efforts to proceed on with the work. The contractor shall have no claim on the damages for extension of time granted or rescheduled must end 4 event listed in clause 5.2. Under this clause, only extension of time will be allowed and no damages for extension will be is eligible under this clause. In the case the work is hindered by the department, the 5.3 delay is the delay on the part of the department. In case the work is hindered by the department or any other reason event for which action the department is responsible, the authority as indicated in Schedule F shall, if justified, give a fair and reasonable extension of time and reschedule the milestone for completion of the work. The rescheduling should be done based on the records available. Such extension of time or rescheduling of the milestone shall be without prejudice to any other right or remedy of the party in the contract or in law. The contractor shall be entitled to only extension of time and no damages. Whether it is delay on account of nature calamity or the delay on the part of the department, only UT will be granted and there will be no damages. Request for rescheduling of milestone or extension of time to be eligible for consideration shall be made by the contractor in writing within 14 days of happening of the event causing delay in the prescribed form. The contract shall indicate the period by which rescheduling of milestone or extension of time is required. With every request for rescheduling milestone or at any time, the actual progress of the work filed behind the approved program by more than 10% on the stipulated period completion contract, the contractor shall produce a revised program. If the contractor is requesting for rescheduling of milestone and progress as per earlier approved program, if it is more than 10%, delay is more than 10%, then contractor has to submit revised program. This revised program shall include all details of pending drawing, decision required to complete the contract, and also the target by which the details should be available without causing any delay in execution of the work, and it should match with the milestone fixed, the stage fixed or milestone. Whatever details, whatever drawing are to be given, milestone by it should be handed over. It is the duty of the engineer charge to see to get the work done within the time, stipulated time of period. It should be handed over as per the program fixed to achieve the work within the targeted period. In any such case, the authority at Schedule F may give a fair and reasonable extension of time for completion of work or rescheduling of the milestone. Engineering charge shall finalize reschedule milestone before taking an action against the subsequent milestones. Such extension or reschedule milestone shall be communicated to the contractor by the authority agent who should have in writing within 21 days of date of receipt of such request from the contractor in prescribed form. In the event of non-application by the contractor for extension of time, the engineering charge, after affording opportunity to the contractor, may give, supported with the program, a fair, reasonable extension with reasonable time of occurrence of the events. In case when contractor is not applying for EOT or rescheduling milestone, then it is the duty of the engineering charge to grant EOT based on the progress achieved as per details with a program, reasonable extension is to be given. Now we come to the hindrance under clause 5.5. The all hindrances in this clause 5.5 is on the part of the contractor. In case the work is delayed by any reason, in the opinion of engineer in charge, by the contractor for reason beyond the event mentioned in clause 5.2 means nature calamity, 5.3 part of the department, 5.4 on the part of the contractor, beyond this justified date without prejudice to the right to take action under clause 3, the engineer charge may grant extension of time required for completion of the work without rescheduling of milestone. In this case, mutual extension beyond justified date the extension is to be given mutual. If contractor is not given his consent for EOT and he is going on with the work silently, you have to write to the contractor, you are going on with the work and as per program and progress achieved by you, the EOT is extended up to such and such, the time is granted up to such and such date, what levy will be, compensation will be levied at the rate such and such for this period. You have to mention. Otherwise, if you contact, you are not writing, there will be contractual complication. The contractor shall be liable for levy of compensation for delay for such extension of time. The provisions of clause 5 are same as per provisions of the construction works, and for maintenance work provisions are same, except only work program is to be submitted considering schedule of drawing. If applicable as specified in schedule F, there will be no handing over of site consideration in this maintenance, etc.
Sir, kuch question hai?
Any doubt?
सर
5.5 एक बार फिर से.
हेलो
सर 5.5 को एक बार फिर से समझ लीजिए.
हाँ सर जो एक्सटेंशन ऑफ टाइम होगा
5.5
जी 5.5 को एक बार फिर से.
एक्सटेंशन विद लेवी कंपनसेशन.
सर जो एक्सटेंशन ऑफ टाइम होना चाहिए वो प्रोविजनल कंप्लीशन सर्टिफिकेट जिस डेट का इशू किया गया वहां तक होगा या एक्चुअल कंप्लीशन.
नाउ देयर इज नो प्रोविजन ऑफ एक्सटेंशन एट ऑल. You have to mention particular date. You have to mention particular time by which the work should be completed.
Sir, provisional completion date ko kya completion date mana jayega?
Provisional completion date in case as per clause 1 is concerned. Clause 1 is concerned. Only subject completion can be a provisional completion is there. But as far as provisional extension is concerned, there is no provision nowadays for provisional extension. You have to give extension under which clause? 5.2, 5.3 or 5.5. There is no provisional extension at all.
No, provisional completion certificate jo rahega, jis date ka karaya tha, sir.
Provisional extension, wo completion aap denge, jis date ko aapki purposeful building complete हो जाए.
जी लेकिन उसके बाद जो बचा हुआ काम है उसको अगर उसने बाद में किया है तो extension of time कहाँ तक होना चाहिए उसका, जो actual date of completion या provisional date of completion?
Actually provisional completion से या provisional extension से आप confused कर रहे हैं, वो अलग चीज है.
नहीं extension नहीं, दो date हो गई ना सर, provisional date of completion हो गई जिसमें हमने provisional certificate दे दिया कि आपका जो है काम हो गया और उसका 80% PG हमने release कर दिया.
Then final completion.
लेकिन उसमें कुछ defect बचे हैं जो हम जो है certificate में mention करते हैं, उस defect को वो बाद में rectify करेगा, उसके बाद जो उसका final completion माना जाएगा. तो क्या provisional date तक जो provisional completion date जो है वहाँ तक अगर उसने जो है कर दिया है, इसका मतलब जो है उसको जो है levy of compensation नहीं लगेगा?
नहीं, इट डजंट बी, नहीं लगेगा. अगर उसने क्लॉज 5 के अगर क्लॉज 5 क्लॉज 2 उसने अगर उसने प्रोविजंस को ओबे किया तो नहीं लगेगा, अगर नहीं किया तो लगेगा.
तो उसको एक्सटेंशन ऑफ टाइम जो है प्रोविजनल डेट कंप्लीशन डेट तक जो लगेगा या टोटल कंप्लीशन डेट जहां तक उसने कंप्लीट किया है वर्क वहां लगेगा, कितने टाइम का लगेगा? 10 दिन मान लीजिए प्रोविजनल कंप्लीशन दिया, उसके बाद 10 दिन बाद जो उसने डिफेक्ट
किया प्रोविजनल कंप्लीशन से, उसका प्रोविजनल कंप्लीशन से और ये क्लॉज 2 क्लॉज 5 में एक्शन लेने का कोई रिलेशन नहीं है. दोनों के अलग अलग एक्शन है, सेपरेट एक्शन है. आप प्रोविजनल कंप्लीशन जो हुआ है वो कब तक हुआ है, वो
एक्सटेंशन ऑफ टाइम ना सर,
क्लॉज 2 क्लॉज 5 में एक्शन
ऑफ टाइम.
हेलो,
तो एक्सटेंशन ऑफ टाइम कहां तक रिक्वायर्ड है उसको, जो है प्रोविजनल कंप्लीशन डेट तक रिक्वायर्ड है या एक्चुअल कंप्लीशन डेट तक?
एक्सटेंशन वहां तक मिलेगा विद ले भी और विदाउट ले भी, जहां तक उसने काम कंप्लीट किया, फाइनल कंप्लीट किया है,
फाइनल कंप्लीट है, प्रोविजनल से उसका कोई रिलेशन नहीं,
प्रोविजनल कंप्लीशन से कोई रिलेशन नहीं है, क्लॉज वन और क्लॉज टू फाइव के जो प्रोविजन है, जो एक्शन लेना है वो अलग अलग है, प्रोविजनल
आवाज नहीं आ रही है
सर, आवाज नहीं आ रही है,
आवाज नहीं आ रही सर। हेलो सर, साउंड नहीं आ रही है। हेलो
हेलो, साउंड नहीं आ रही।
एक मिनट सर, हम बात करते हैं फोन पे उनसे, एक मिनट बात करते हैं।
हेलो हेलो
हेलो
हेलो
कॉन्ट्रैक्ट ये जो पहले आपका हो जाता था कि भाई अंडर एक्शन टू लिया थ्री लिया तो इनवैलिड हो गया आर्बिट्रेशन में, अगर आप इन चीज़ों का ध्यान रखेंगे, इफ यू विल कीप इन माइंड दीज थिंग्स, योर एक्शन विल नॉट बी इन इनवैलिड। नाउ वी कम ऑन क्लॉज सिक्स। नाउ फाइव ए फॉर मेंटेनेंस वर्क्स एस्टिमेटेड कॉस्ट अप टू 25 लाख, दैट क्लॉज बाय प्रोविजंस ऑफ क्लॉज फाइव फॉर मेंटेनेंस वर्क, वर्क फॉर द मेंटेनेंस वर्क मोर देन 25 लाख। नाउ the provisions for maintenance works estimated cost up to 25 lakh. In this case the time allowed for execution of the work as specified on SLU F shall be essence of the contract, means the contract period will not be extended. If time period is 1 month, date is such and such, it will be firm date, there will be no extension at all. The execution of the work shall commence from such time period as mentioned in schedule F, whatever the date is mentioned. What will be the date of schedule F? 1 to 10 days from the letter of intent, it will be date of start. If the contractor commits default in commencing the execution of the work as aforesaid, the PG shall be forfeited by the engineer and shall be absolutely at the disposal of government without prejudice to any other right or remedy available in law. Means in for maintenance work up to 25 lakh, estimated cost up to 25 lakhs, there is no extension of time at all, means contractor has to complete the work within the target, within the stipulated period.
Sir, but now, there is delay from government side, sir.
Sir, if
there is delay from government side, then
already provisions made under clause 2A, wo bataya tha maine.
हाँ,
अगर हिंड्रेंस है, कोई कंपनसेशन नहीं है, हिंड्रेंस पार्शियली हिंड्रेंस है तो हिंड्रेंस फ्री में जितना काम किया है उसको प्रोपोर्शनली फुल स्टिपुलेटेड टाइम से कंपेयर करना है। अगर कंपेरेबली उतना काम कर दिया है, नो कंपनसेशन नहीं किया था, देयर विल बी कंपनसेशन ऑन प्रो रेटा बेसिस।
अच्छा सर, टाइम इज द एसेंस ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट फॉर ओनली अप टू 25 लाख, मोर देन 25 लाख इट इज
इन दैट केस आल्सो इफ एक्सचेंज मे बी ग्रांटेड। इसमें टाइम ऑफ इसेंस ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट हियर मींस जो स्टिपुलेटेड टाइम है इसेंस ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट। इन कंस्ट्रक्शन अदर इफ जस्टिफाइड पीरियड इज देयर एक्सटेंशन इज गिवन दैट विल बी द इसेंस ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट।
ओके सर,
in maintenance work, only work has to be covered with the stupidity. ये आप लोगों के फायदे के लिए किया है जो आठ आठ महीने दो दस दस बीस बीस हजार के काम चलते रहते थे.
यस सर, बट क्या फॉरफेचर के लिए हमें लेटर इशू करना पड़ेगा या ऑटोमेटिक है कि उसने विद इन टाइम खत्म नहीं किया?
किसका
मेंटेनेंस वर्क? मान लो विद इन वन मंथ था उसका टाइम और उसने कंप्लीट नहीं किया, पीजी फॉरफेट कर दिया हमने, क्या उसको नोटिस इशू किया जाएगा? अगर नोटिस इशू किया जाएगा तो किस क्लॉज के तहत? 5A में करेंगे.
आप पढ़ा नहीं आपने ठीक से पढ़ी. ये देखें, इफ द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट कमिट डिफॉल्ट इन कमेंसिंग द एजुकेशन ऑफ द वर्क, कमेंसिंग मींस जो आपकी डेट ऑफ स्टार्ट है उस पर शुरू करना, देन पीजी करनी है आपको. काम शुरू कर दिया, पूरा काम नहीं किया, कुछ काम किया तो लेवी कंपनसेशन करना है. एंड यू हैव टू टेक एक्शन अंडर क्लॉज 2.
सर सर, ये डाउट नोटिस करना है विद नोटिस करना है फॉरफिट
किसमें?
जब कॉन्ट्रैक्टर स्टार्ट नहीं कर रहा है, कमेंस नहीं कर रहा है काम,
नोटिस तो देना ही देना है.
टाइम पीरियड के अंदर अगर कंप्लीट नहीं कर रहा है तो उसपे लेवी कंपनसेशन.
हाँ, नोटिस तो देना, लेवी कंपनसेशन हुआ ही हुआ. और शुरू नहीं किया तो पीजी उसकी फीडबैक करनी है,
फॉरफिट करनी
है.
सर नमस्कार.
नमस्कार
सर, कोई वर्क अगर क्लास 3 में सस्पेंड हुआ है, मेंटेनेंस वर्क हो, क्या उसका
क्लास
सस्पेंड कर दिया? सस्पेंड कर दिया क्योंकि काम नहीं करना चाहता कॉन्ट्रैक्टर वो?
नहीं, डिटरमाइन किया, सस्पेंड नहीं, डिटरमाइन किया.
हाँ, डिटरमाइन किया है तो क्या उसका ईओटी केस बनेगा?
ईओटी केस
काम तो बनेगा उसका,
बनेगा, पक्का बनेगा. एक्शन कैसे लोगे फिर उसे अंडर क्लॉज 2?
अच्छा, मतलब उसके साथ, मतलब अगर उसका पीजी फॉरफिट करेंगे तो उसके साथ साथ ईओटी केस भी बनाएंगे,
अंडर क्लॉज 2 एक्शन लेना पड़ेगा. भाई पीजी तभी तो फॉरफिट कर रहे हैं कि टाइम इज नॉट गोइंग ऑन एज पर ड्यू डिलीजेंस.
सर,
पेनल्टी कौन कौन सी इम्पोज होगी सर उसमें? क्या माइलस्टोन वाली भी होगी, क्लॉज 2 की सारी होगी?
आगे चले
सर, एक क्वेश्चन है
सर, क्लॉज 3 में 3 के अंदर डिटरमाइंड है, उसमें कौन कौन सी पेनल्टीज है?
हेलो,
आप जब तक माइक बंद नहीं करेंगे तब तक काम नहीं चलेगा. जिसको पूछना वो माइक ऑन करे. बाबा जी बिल्कुल नहीं आ रही है, बोलिए, अब बोलिए.
सर एक क्वेश्चन है.
सर,
रीशेड्यूलिंग ऑफ माइलस्टोन करने से अगर पेमेंट की जो कंडीशन है वो अफेक्ट हो रही है तो क्या ये किया जा सकता है? स्पेशली ईपीसी कॉन्ट्रैक्ट में जिसमें जो रीशेड्यूलिंग करते हैं उसके बाद जो है जो पेमेंट कंडीशन रहती है वो परसेंटेज वाइज रहती है, उसमें कोई जो है शेड्यूल नहीं रहता है, कभी शेड्यूल ऑफ क्वांटिटी, तो ऐसी कंडीशन में क्या किया जाए?
सर साउंड क्लियर नहीं है ना, ना पीपीटी
भी आवाज नहीं आ रही बिल्कुल आपकी.
अरे सर, सब लोग ऑन कर देंगे ना माइक तो दिक्कत होगी, इकू होता है ना जी, एक एक
जिसको पूछना है वो पूछे तभी मैं सुन पाऊंगा.
चलिए सर आगे चलिए.
हां ठीक. Now, become a clause says computerized measurement for construction works. All measurement of all items having financial value shall be entered by the contractor and compiled in the shape of the computerized measurement book having pages A4 size as per the format of the department, so that the company record is obtained of all items of works performed under the contract. Whenever bill is due for payment, the contractor would initially submit draft computerized measurement sheets and these measurements shall be got checked or test checked from the engineer in charge or his authorized representative. The measurement sheets submitted by the contractor will be checked or test checked by the engineer in charge or the authorized
representative. इसमें सर्च का एक ऑप्शन होता है, तो जो नाम है उसको यहाँ डाला.
The contractor will thereafter incorporate such changes as may be done during these checks or test checks in his draft computerized measurement and submit to the department a computerized measurement book duly bound and with its pages machine number. The engineer charge or his authorized representative would thereafter check this MB and record the necessary certificate for the checks or test checks. the fair, final fair computerized measurement book given by the contractor duly bound with its page and machine number should be 100% correct. Means in computerized measurement book, no correction is allowed. It should be 100% correct, correction free. And no cutting or overwriting in the measurement book thereafter will be allowed. The contractor
slide is not coming. सर नमस्ते सर इसका मतलब है कि सर वेद प्रकाश उसमें जो मेजरमेंट्स हैं इनिशियली जो साइड मेजरमेंट वो करके दे रहे हैं वो लूज शीट्स में भी इंजीनियरिंग चार्ज को दी जाएंगी
जी जी
फाइंड अप होंगे मतलब हम लूज शीट्स में भी पहले मेजरमेंट्स को देके उनको वो चेक करा सकते हैं
चेक कराएगा चेक करने के बाद फेयर देगा बाउंड
सर थैंक यू सर
बट दी शीट सबमिटेड इन ड्राफ्ट आल्सो इट शुड बी ऑन A4 साइज It should be machine number and area 4 size.
Sir, वो तो machine number तो नहीं होगी ना sheet तो.
Hello.
Sir, machine number नहीं होगी ना loose sheets तो. Loose sheets.
हाँ हाँ. बाद में fair होने के बाद होगी.
Hello.
Hello.
Sir. Hello. Finally जो check हो जाएगा उसमें test check करने पे पड़ेगा.
Sir, computerized जो वो मेजरमेंट शीट बनाएगा तो क्या वो पर डे ऑफिस में जमा करेगा चेक करने के लिए इंजीनियरिंग चार्ज को
इट इज टू बी डिसाइडेड बाय यू अब वो एक दिन ही 1000 शीट पकड़ा देगा आपको तो कैसे चेक करेंगे
तो क्या वो पर डे देगा सर
यू हैव टू फिक्स दी
मेजरमेंट वगैरह सब जो भी हिजर मेजरमेंट है वो सेम डे सबमिट होता है
स्टील का मेजरमेंट है अदर जो मेजरमेंट है
हां
वो उस दिन को ही देगा शाम को देगा या मतलब कल कास्टिंग है तो आज पहले देगा वो
पहले देगा
किस चीज के मेजरमेंट्स
स्टील रेनफोर्समेंट के मेजरमेंट है सपोज
वो तो पहले देगा तो आपको पता कि चेक करना है आपको
पहले देगा सर
तो वो पहले देगा पहले देगा सर
हां
हाउ मेनी डेज बिफोर कास्टिंग
इट इज टू बी डिसाइडेड बाय यू कि आपको चेक करने में टाइम लगता है बताइए इतना टाइम लगेगा भाई अथॉरिटी तो आप हैं इसमें
सफिशिएंट टाइम
पास करना है
हेलो
बिल तो आपको प्रोसेस करना है
हेलो हेलो
हेलो
सर नमस्कार
नमस्कार
सर ये पूछना चाह रहे थे जैसे कॉन्ट्रैक्टर मेजरमेंट जमा करता है
जी
अगर वो उसमें बहुत ज्यादा गलतियां करता है डेलिबरेटरी लगता है कि वो गलतियां कर रहा है
जी
तो इसमें क्या हमारा डिपार्टमेंट एक्शन ले सकता है
इसमें तो इतना आप करेक्ट मेजरमेंट ले बस इतना कर सकते हैं क्या कर सकते हैं दूसरा अंडर क्लॉज 32 आपको लगता है जो आदमी गड़बड़ कर रहा है उसे हटा दीजिए वहां से
जी सर
अंडर क्लॉज 32 आएगी जब 32 में बताऊंगा उसमें जिस चाहे आदमी को आपको लगता है कि ये गड़बड़ कर रहा है उसको साइड से हटा दीजिए
जैसे सर उसने मेजरमेंट सबमिट की मान लिया 10 पेज सबमिट किए और उसमें से पता लगा 80% 70% गलत ही सबमिट है
तो इसको बिल्कुल पक्का है उसको हटा दीजिए वहाँ से एक्चुअली अंडर क्लॉज 32 है ये डिपार्टमेंट की कॉस्ट पे वो जितना स्टाफ टेक्निकल स्टाफ है तो उसको उसमें से आपको लगता है इस आदमी ने गलत काम किया जिसे मेजरमेंट लिया है यू रिमूव फ्रॉम द साइट
जी सर जी
छोटे काम के तो मेजरमेंट आप ले लोगे बड़े काम के क्या रोज कहाँ मेजरमेंट ले पाएंगे
जी सर जी जी सर
बाकी ऐसा कर रहे ठेकेदार कितने लोग कर रहे हैं जैसे आप बता रहे हो
सर एक दो इंसिडेंट ऐसे हुए हैं जिसमें कंप्यूटराइज मेजरमेंट में डेलिबरेटली गलतियां ज्यादा की गई हैं
वैसे इसमें ना अगर आप काम कितने का है कितने करोड़ का काम है
ये 6 करोड़ का सर
आप अगर चाहें अगर बी ओ योर इंचार्ज और सी ए डी जी इंटीग्रिटी इम्पैक्ट इंटीग्रिटी बॉन्ड जो साइन कराते हो ना आप उससे
जी सर जी
आप उसमें अंडर एक्शन ले सकते हो उसको
जी सर
डिटरमाइन कर सकते हो कॉन्ट्रैक्टर को अगर एक्शन लेना चाहते हो अगर ये दो बार दूसरी बार अगर ऐसा करता है तो
हाँ जी हाँ जी
अगर इंटीग्रिटी डाउटफुल है वो तो आपके पास बहुत बड़ा हथियार है अगर आप यूज करना चाहें तो उसे
जी सर जी
बट इट शुड बी यूज वेरी जुडिशियसली
यस सर
कोर्ट के बहुत चक्कर लगाने पड़ेंगे इसमें आपको उसको करप्ट प्रूव करना पड़ेगा
जी सर जी
सर एक क्वेश्चन सर इन ईपीसी कॉन्ट्रैक्ट में तो वो किस चीज का मेजरमेंट जमा करेगा सर वहां तो कोई
मेजरमेंट आगे बताऊंगा मैं क्या करेगा आएगा उसका बताऊंगा स्टेज वाइज करेगा बताऊंगा सर the contractor shall also submit separately computer abstract of cost and the bill based on these measurement duly bound pages machine number along with two spare copy, then this bill will be processed for payment. The contractor shall without extra charge provide all assistance with every appliance, labor and other things necessary for checking of the measurements. Except where any general or detailed description of work express shows to the contrary, measurements shall be taken in accordance with the procedure set forth in the specifications, not with the standing in the relevant standard method of measurement or
hello sir method. Hello
hello
hello sir
हाँ
सर ये पीपीटी नहीं चल रही है सर केवल फ्रंट पेज दिख रहा है किसी का
के मिश्रा जी ऑनलाइन है क्या
आपका इंटरनेट
दिख रही है के मिश्रा जी
ये सर ये सर
भैया इनका थोड़ा सा
दिख रहा है दिख रहा है
सर आपकी क्लास 6 दिख रहा है मेजरमेंट ऑफ वर्क डन
दिख रहा है सर
इनकी प्रॉब्लम होगी सर नेट की
देखिए जल्दी
शर्मा जी नेट चेक करो अपना
आप अपना प्रॉब्लम वहां देखिए यहां ठीक चल रहा सर
लोकल वहां थोड़ा दिखवाए अपने ऑफिस में शायद कोई गड़बड़ हो इन द केस ऑफ आइटम व्हिच आर नॉट कवर्ड बाय द स्पेसिफिकेशंस मेजरमेंट शैल बी टेकन इन अकॉर्डिंग विद द रिलेवेंट स्टैंडर्ड मेथड ऑफ मेजरमेंट्स इशूड बाय BIS ब्यूरो ऑफ इंडियन स्टैंडर्ड इफ फॉर एनी आइटम नो सच स्टैंडर्ड इज अवेलेबल then a mutually agreed method will be followed. The contractor shall give not less than 7 days notice before covering up or otherwise placing beyond the reach of checking or test checking the measurement of any work in order that the same may be checked or test checked before the same is covered. So the contract 7 days ka notice dega aapko ki ye work maine kar diya hai isko main cover kar raha hu usse pehle 7 days mein then engineer in charge or his authorized representative shall within the aforesaid period of 7 days inspect the work. If any work is covered up or placed beyond the reach without such notice shall be uncovered by the or at the contractor expense. In default thereof no payment or allowance shall be made for such work or material with which the same is executed. The engineer in charge or his authorized representative may call either themselves or through another officer of the department to check the measurements recorded by the contractor. Engineer in charge or authorized representative or any agency can check the measurements. It is also the contract. It is term of the contract that recording of measurement in MB or its payment in the interim on account of final bill shall not be considered as conclusive evidence as the sufficiency of the work and material to which it relates nor shall it relieve the contractor from liability from any over measurements or defects noticed till completion of the defect liability period. Means if any measurement is taken and the work is defective or overpayment has been paid up to defect liability period, the contractor is liable to defect the to remove the defects, replace the material, and the payment will be adjusted. Means if measurement is taken of any item, it doesn't mean the item has been executed as per terms and condition of the contract. It is safeguard for the department to take under this clause 6-11 in such cases. Now, computer measurement for EPC project, same provisions except the following para 6-1 measurements. All measurements as per stage payment mentioned in Schedule F having financial value shall be entered by the contractor and comply in the shape of the computer measurement book having pages for size as per the format of the department so that a complete record is obtained in all stages of the work performed under the contract and other conditions regarding checking or test checking of the measurements or providing assistant to the department for checking or check the measurement checked, all provisions are as per the provisions of the construction works. For maintenance, all provisions same as for construction works. Any question?
Yes, sir.
Hmm.
सर ईपीसी मोड में जो हमारा सर लेवल वाइज पेमेंट है
जी,
लेकिन बाकी सारे पेपर बनाने के लिए जो हमारा कन्वेंशनल मेजरमेंट ढंग होता था, जैसे एमएमटीसी बनानी है, कंज्यूमशन बनाने हैं, टेस्ट चेक का बनाना है, इंडियन आइटम के अलग बनाने हैं, मैंडेटरी टेस्ट के परफॉर्मा बनाना है, इनकी सारे जो अंदर के डेटास के लिए हमें कन्वेंशनल टाइप के मेजरमेंट करना पड़ता है,
करना पड़ता है। यस
ठीक है सर
जी।
अब वो करना पड़ता है और वो एक्यूरेट उतनी ही एक्यूरेट होनी चाहिए,
और
या वो उसको उसको बाद में, नहीं नहीं फायदा तो अलग चीज है, उसको लेकर के किसी भी आइटम को लेकर के उसे बाद में आर्बिट्रेशन में मेरा इतना था, मेरा स्कोप में इतना था और ये सब चीजें हो जाए, तो वो क्या ऑथेंटिक रिकॉर्ड माना जाएगा एज पर एग्रीमेंट?
अभी तक तो ऑथेंटिक जो किया है वो माना जाएगा, लेकिन ईपीसी के लिए ये क्लोज अंडर मॉडिफिकेशन है, अभी डिसीजन आया नहीं है, कमेटी आपकी बनाई हुई है मेरे ख्याल से, अब डिसीजन अभी आया नहीं है, अंडर कंसीडरेशन है। मैं पिछले भी लेक्चर में
अभी सर फायदा क्या होगा सर अभी
नहीं, एक्चुअली ईपीसी फिर मोड का जो काम है, लेट मी फिनिश सर प्लीज, जो ईपीसी को काम करने का, इसे लाइट करने का ढंग बनाया गया था स्पीड के लिए और सब चीजों के लिए, वो तो पर्पस डिफीट हो गया सर,
पर्पस डिफीट हो गया। यस
तो सारे लोग उसी में लगे हैं, बल्कि अब तो और ज्यादा लगे हैं, उस ढंग से भी बनाते हैं, उस ढंग से भी बनाते हैं, एक और चीज हो गई।
लेकिन
ये और एक्यूरेसी लेवल भी सर, एक्यूरेसी लेवल क्या उतना ही मेंटेन करना है, ये सबसे सीरियस बात है सर।
हाँ हाँ,
क्योंकि अगर वंस वी आर डूइंग मेजरमेंट एंड साइनिंग इट, इट इज इट कैन बी क्लेम्ड एनीवेयर।
जो आप कर रहे हो तो मतलब
है ना सर, तो उसके बाद मतलब नहीं, तो वो जो एक लिबर्टी है कि ईपीसी मोड में बड़ा इजी हो जाएगा और ये सब चीजें हम साइट पे ज्यादा वो कर पाएंगे, तो पर्पस डिफीटेड।
पर इसके लिए लिखा है मॉडिफिकेशन में टाइम लगेगा थोड़ा सा, कंसीडरेशन में है जहां तक मुझे पता है।
अच्छा,
अभी डिसीजन नहीं हुआ है,
लेकिन ये कहीं मेंशन नहीं है सर कि, लेकिन सर ये कहीं मेंशन भी नहीं है कि हमें पूरी मेजरमेंट एज इट इज करनी है जैसे पहले कन्वेंशनल करते थे।
नहीं, क्लॉज 6 आप पढ़िए, यही करना है, क्या करना है आप देखिए ना,
ईपीसी मोड में सर।
हाँ
देखिए सर,
कंप्यूटर मेजर उसमें दिया, कंप्यूटर जो दिया है आप,
नहीं तो शेड्यूल एफ में तो लेवल वाइज पेमेंट की बात है सर, तो उस तरह से हम मेजरमेंट करेंगे। लेवल वाइज
पेमेंट किया, 6 बन कर दिया, बाकी जो और प्रोविजंस उन्होंने रखे हैं सारे के सारे वही रखे हैं, जो प्रोविजंस रखे हैं जो मेंशन किए हैं ईपीसी प्रोजेक्ट के लिए जो बनाए इन्होंने,
राइट सर,
सब सेम प्रोविजंस है।
ठीक है सर, इन एडिशन टू दैट, ये इन एडिशन टू दैट, ठीक है सर।
लेकिन सिर्फ इसमें जो फायदा मिलना चाहिए, जो हम सोच रहे थे कि भाई कुछ नहीं नाप दिया, एक स्टेज वाइज है, छोटा सा काम है, हो जाएगा, लेकिन जो अंदर वाली चीजें जो है वो अभी मॉडिफाई नहीं हो पाई है, वो होना चाहिए मॉडिफाई।
ठीक है सर।
पेमेंट ऑफ इंटरमीडिएट सर्टिफिकेट टू बी रिगार्डेड एज एडवांस पेमेंट मीन्स All payment, running payment made to the contractor has to be treated as advance payment as per provisions of clause 7. What do you mean by advance payment? Means if at any stage you feel the payment is not in order, means the payment has been made on higher side or payment has been made for the defective work, then you can adjust any amount of the bill from final bill or running bill from any bill. That's why any payment made before final payment is called advance. No payment shall be made for work estimated cost to be 20 lakhs or less till after the whole of the work shall have completed certificate of completion given. Up to 20 lakh there is no running payment, and if the work's estimated cost over rupees 20 lakh, the interim or any account bill shall be submitted by the contractor for the work executed on the basis of such recorded measurement on the format of the department in triplicate on or before the date of every month fixed for the same by the engineering charge. You have to fix the date as per the progress achieved by the contractor. Date fixed by you, you ask the contractor, you submit the bill by such and such date. You have to make the bill within 10 days at headquarters and outside headquarter, you have 15 days time to make the payments. Accordingly, you ask the contractor to submit the measurement or bill and measurement by such and such date, so that payment may be paid by the date fixed for the payment. The amount admissible shall be paid by 10th working day after the date of presentation of the bill by the contractor to the engineer in charge or his assistant engineer, together with the account of the material issued by the department or dismantled material, if any. In case of works outside headquarter, the engineer in charge, the period of 10 working days will be extended to the 15 working days. In case of delay on payment of intermediate bills, after 45 days of submission of the bill by the contractor, provided that the bill submitted by the contractor found to be in order, a simple interest at the rate of 5% per annum shall be paid to the contractor from the date of expiry of prescribed time limit, which will be compounded on a yearly basis. Means you have to make the payment within 10 days or outside headquarters within 15 days. If the payment has been made after 45 days, then you have to make the payment of interest at the rate of 5% per annum beyond 10 days to the date of payment. Specify payment expiry of prescribed period means 10 days or 15 days. It is prescribed period. And if payment made within 45 days, no interest to be paid. If payment is made after 45 days, you have to make the payment of interest from the 11 or 16. It is headquarter.
सर एक इसमें प्रॉब्लम है
जी,
जैसे इसमें दिया है कि इंटरेस्ट देने का आफ्टर 45 डेज
जी,
जो 10 डेज और 15 डेज की लिमिट है
जी,
लास्ट 45 डेज में तो लिखा है प्रोवाइडेड द बिल सबमिटेड बाय द कॉन्ट्रैक्टर फाउंड टू बी इन ऑर्डर
ऑर्डर यस,
और 10 और 15 डेज में ये लाइन नहीं है, तो क्या वो कैसा भी सबमिट कर दे तो 10 डेज उस सबमिशन डेट से माना जाएगा?
नहीं नहीं, ऑर्डर वहां भी ऑर्डर है, ये छोटा मैंने बनाया आपके जीसी
में लिखा हुआ है। ओके ओके
ओके, ये तो मैंने फिर तो ये आएगा ही नहीं है कि उसमें स्लाइड में भर जाएगा।
नहीं नहीं नहीं, मतलब दिस लाइन इज देयर आल्सो,
ये वहां भी है।
ओके, मींस आफ्टर करेक्टेड एंड टेस्ट चेक बिल सब कुछ ऑर्डर में हो गया, देन ओनली 10 डेज एंड 15 डेज।
यस, ओके। All such Indian payment shall be regarded as payment by way of advances against final payment only, and shall not preclude the requiring of bad, unsound, imperfect, unskilled work to be rejected, removed, taken away, or reconstructed or re-erected. Means, agar kisi running payment ho gayi hai, to usko bhi contractor has to remove the defect, reconstructed under the provisions of this clause 7. Pending consideration of extension of time, extension date of completion, interim payment shall continue to be made as herein, provided without prejudice to the right of department to take action under the terms of the contract for delay in the execution of the work. If the extension of time, extension of date of completion is not granted by the competent authority, if extension has not been granted, even then intermediate running account bill may be paid, but mentioning that the department has to liberty to take action under the terms of the contract for delay of the completion of the work. The engineer charge, in his sole discretion on the basis of certificate from assistant engineer to effect that the work has been completed up to level in question, making interim advance payment without detailed measurement other than foundation item, cupboard and the finishing item, etc., up to lintel level or slab level for each floor working out 75% of the assessed value. If the measurement has not been taken, work has been executed, then on the certificate of the assessed engineer that such and such quantity has been executed, then 75% of the assessed value, the payment may be made, advance payment. The advance payment so allowed shall be adjusted in the subsequent interim bill to be submitted by the contractor within 10 days of the interim payment. In case delay the submission of the bill by the contractor, a simple interest of 10% per annum shall be paid to the government from the date of expiry of prescribed time limit, which will be compounded on yearly basis. Advance payment, a contractor has to submit running account within 10 days. If he does not submit, then simple interest of 10% per annum will be levied. In case of composite tenders, running payment for major components shall be made by EE of the major discipline to the main contractor. Running payment for the minor component shall be made by the in charge of the discipline of minor component directly to the main contractor. In case main contractor fails to make the payment to the contractor associated by him within 15 days of receipt of each running account payment, then on the written complaint of the contractor associated for such minor component, engineer in charge of minor component shall serve the show cause notice to the main contractor, and if reply of the main contractor either not received or found unsatisfactory, he may make the payment directly to the contractor associated for minor component as per the terms and condition of the agreement drawn between the main contractor and the associate contractor. The payment of associate contractor means minor subhead, the payment may be made by the engineer charge of the minor component, and this payment will be recovered by the engineering charge of the major or minor, whoever made the payment earlier. Such payment made to associate contractor shall be recovered by the in charge of major or minor component from the next area of final bill due to main contractor as the case may be. For maintenance, all provisions are as per provisions of construction works, except running bill will be allowed only if the estimated cost put to tender is rupees 5 lakhs or more. Now, for EPC project, the running account bill shall be submitted by the contractor for the work executed on the basis of such recorded measurements as per clause 6 on the format in triplicate on or before the date of every month fixed for the same. Measurement will be taken as per provisions of the clause 6. Means stage wise, the contractor shall not be entitled to be paid any such interim payment if the gross value of work together with net payment adjustment by advances of material since last such payment is less than the amount as specified in schedule F. The amount admissible shall be paid by 10th working day of presentation of the bill by the contractor to the engineering charge or his assistant engineer together with the account of material issued by the department of discipline and material penny. In case works outside the headquarters of engineering charge, the period of 10 working days will be extended to 15 working days. In case of delay in payment, intermediate bills after 45 days of submission of the bill by the contractor, provided the bill submitted by the contractor found to be notary simple interest of 5% annual shall be paid to the contractor from the date of expiry prescribed time limit, which will be compounded yearly basis. All such payment shall be regarded as payment by way of advances against the payment only and shall not preclude the requiring of bad, unsound or improper unskilled work or to be rejected, removed, taken by or reconstructed or re-erected. Pending consideration of extension date of completion, interim payment shall continue to be made as herein provided without prejudice to the right of department to take action under the terms of the contract for delay in completion of the work if the extension of time of completion is not granted by the competent authority. Now, clause 7A, it is common for construction, EPC and construction. No running account bill shall be paid for the work till the applicable labor license registered with EPFO, ESIC and BOCW building and other construction works will pay board whatever applicable submitted by the contractor to the engineering charge. Now this is clause 7B, new clause, payment to the third party. Construction, EPC, maintenance, common provisions are there. If the exigency of the work so demand, the engineering charge may allow payment to a third party who is credited to the contractor after fulfilling the following conditions. Agar thekedar ne kisi se पैसा लिया है, सामान लिया है, तो एन एजेंसी इज देयर मींस टू टू प्रोग्रेस ऑफ द वर्क, द एजेंसी इज नॉट पोजीशन टू अरेंज द मटेरियल और टू द टू अरेंज द फाइनेंशियल फाइनेंशियल इन द वर्क देन एंड इफ यू टेक देन एंड कंडीशन इज देयर यू कैन मेक द पेमेंट विद थर्ड पार्टी इफ एन एजेंसी इज देयर सीइंग द प्रोग्रेस ऑफ द वर्क एजेंसी ऑफ द वर्क देन इंजीनियरिंग चार्ज में अलाउ पेमेंट टू थर्ड पार्टी हुज क्रेडिटर जिसने इसको उधार दिया है आफ्टर फुलफिलिंग द फॉलोइंग कंडीशन द कॉन्ट्रैक्टर गिव्स एन अथॉरिटी लेटर एड्रेस टू द इंजीनियरिंग चार्ज ऑन ए नॉन जुडिशियल स्टाम्प पेपर बी हंड्रेड द फॉर्मेट गिवन बिलो आई बी हियरबाय ऑथराइज द ई सच एंड सच डिवीजन टू पे डायरेक्टली ऑन माई बिहाफ टू नेम अ पार्टी ऑन अमाउंट ऑफ सच एंड सच रुपी फॉर द वर्क डन और सप्लाई मेड बाई नेम ऑफ थर्ड पार्टी I shall be responsible for the quality, quantity of the same under the provision of the agreement number such and such. The total payment of third party or parties shall not exceed 10% of agreement cost of the work put to tender. Four reasons of proposing such third party payment shall be recorded and prior written approval of the next higher authority shall be obtained before making such payment. In case of making the payment to third party, the approval of the next higher authority shall be obtained before making such a payment.
Sir, इसमें एक point था सर.
Hello.
सर जो third party word आया third party का मतलब इसमें associate agency को भी बोल रहा है क्या या दूसरा associate के अलावा किसी का payment नहीं दिया ठेकेदार ने petty contractor उनकी third party मान रहा है या associate agency को third party मान रहा है ये थोड़ा clear करो.
फॉर प्रोग्रेस ऑफ द वर्क अगर उसने कोई सामान लेना है वो अरेंज नहीं कर पा रहा है अगर वो चाहता है कि थर्ड पार्टी को पेमेंट आप सीधे कर दो इसे अंडरटेकिंग देने के बाद यू कैन मेक द पेमेंट डायरेक्टली टू द थर्ड पार्टी वो नहीं कि किसी का उधार ले लिया है तो उसको पेमेंट करना है वो नहीं करना
इसमें जो एसोसिएट एजेंसी है उसकी उससे मतलब नहीं है अलग क्लोज काम करेगी
ना ना उसे कोई मतलब नहीं है
ठीक है ओके सर थैंक यू
आपके काम के लिए जो चाहिए उसके लिए आप कर सकते हैं
हमें समझ गया बस मैं थोड़ा सा मतलब ठीक है
तो सर सामान के लिए होगा तो इट्स अ सॉर्ट ऑफ एडवांस पेमेंट
नहीं एडवांस पेमेंट क्या हुआ पहले ले चुका होगा
तो सर तो सामान लेने के बाद ना पेमेंट करना होगा सर
हाँ
सामान लेने के एडवांस पेमेंट कोई नहीं होती लेने के बाद
सामान है सर्विस है कोई भी सर्विस ले रहा है और ही इज नॉट इन पोजीशन उसका होने के बाद यू कैन मेक पेमेंट In some cases, to some, the 90% work has been completed, 10% remaining to the financial crunches. Our contractor is not in position to arrange the material. Then you can allow third party payment. Yes, it is in work interest. It should be in a work interest.
Sir, ये payment जो होगा, ये running account bill के उसमें shape में होगा? क्योंकि इसमें एजेंसी का नाम तो कॉन्ट्रैक्टर का तो एक साइन किया हुआ लेटर होगा लेकिन
लेटर होगा और यस रनिंग अकाउंट बिल पे होगा उसके सिग्नेचर लेंगे इसके
सर
बिल पे होगा
जी
हेलो
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 हेलो हाँ बोलिए
हेलो सर
हाँ हाँ बोलिए
हाउ टू डिटरमिन द एसेट वैल्यू ऑफ द वर्क फॉर व्हिच द एडवांस पेमेंट कैन बी मेड
कितना वर्क आपका बचा है हाउ मच वर्क इज बैलेंस हाउ मच यू आर आस्किंग फॉर थर्ड पार्टी पेमेंट और
आई एम आस्किंग अबाउट द एडवांस पेमेंट अलाउड फॉर द पेमेंट to the agency for the works partly done
in case of payment in clause 7
nahi hum usme likhe hain na ki 75% of the asset value advance ke roop mein diya sakta hai earlier pages mein hai sir wo
under clause 7
sir wo yahi certify karke dega ki ha actual mein itna ho chuka hai uska 75% dete hain
एडवांस
यस यस यू आर राइट
work done but not measured.
वो यही सर्टिफाई करके देगा पहले
The in charge has sole discretion on the basis of certificate given by AE. 75% assessed value. Hello?
Assets value.
Assets value. Asset नहीं है, assets value. Assets
नहीं
है,
assets
value. जो lintel level तक कितने का काम हो गया? You can assess.
75% of the
roof level तक कितना हो गया? उस काम का 75% देना है.
Assess value of the work done.
Assess करना है.
Assess value of the work done by the site in charge.
Yes. ठीक है.
हाँ सर ठीक है. Proceed करते हैं.
एक बजे आप lunch कर लीजिए. 2 बजे मिलते हैं. ठीक है.
ठीक है सर. सर.
ये शाम 2 बजे मिलेंगे. थोड़ा ज़्यादा time चाहिएगा.
बिल्कुल 2 बजे मिलेंगे.